year to this year. He's made a huge improvement, so we really pushed him hard in the off season to get better, and then even the summer he did a really good job on his own back home to get better. And the competition has helped. We've got pretty good competition there at kicker, and I think that's made him a better player. And if you ask him, I bet he'll tell you the same exact thing. But very proud of him for going 3-3 and having the best night of his college career.
They're always positive, and always those things you can work on coming out of the first game of the season. And one number that really jumped off the stat page was third down conversions. UAM finished up 8 out of 19 in that category. The Wonder Boys 1 out of 14. Was there anything from an execution standpoint in particular that you really pointed to that drove either one of those numbers that you want to try to improve upon in week two and beyond?
Well, a lot of it was what happened on first and second down. Getting us in some long situations, whether it be a penalty or one guy missing his block or a misread by a running back or a misread by the quarterback. There were a lot of little small things, and it really happened a lot to us in the second half. And that comes back to a little bit of conditioning and a little bit of just lack of execution. And that's stuff we worked on this week, and hopefully that'll show up tonight.
We'll step aside for just a moment and then come back to talk about the Ouachita Baptist Tigers. This is Arkansas Tech Football.
Joshua's Fine Jewelry, a luxury establishment in the heart of downtown Russellville, are taking it back to the good old days with a family-owned, family-operated business that prides themselves on personal interactions, beautiful custom craftsmanship, and an insanely knowledgeable and helpful staff that go above and beyond just for you. Joshua's Fine Jewelry is giving a huge shout-out to all of our local River Valley and Natural State athletes. You guys are the real MVPs. Be sure to like Joshua's Fine Jewelry on Facebook today, and then give them a visit in downtown Russellville at 310 West Main Street.
Did you know if your roof isn't maintained regularly, you could void the warranty on your existing roof? Tim Noblett with E&F Roofing has made it his mission to protect your roof or help you get the new roof that will maximize your investment and extend the life of your roof, which can save you money through prevention and maintenance. So before you have another company check your roof, call 479-272-4069 and let E&F Roofing see what they can find and how much you can save by using someone local, someone who cares, right here in the River Valley. Why trust River Valley Tinting and Glass? Well, River Valley Tinting and Glass is a family-owned business, and they take care of their customers like family do. So remember, your local auto, residential, and commercial glass and tinting company, River Valley Tinting and Glass. Check out their work on Facebook or call 890-5839 to get an estimate. Or you can always come by 2202 East 2nd Street to see all they can do for you. From a business you can trust, River Valley Tinting and Glass.
Taking care of families. That's what the folks at C&D Drugstore have been doing in historic downtown Russellville for more than six decades when it comes to all your pharmaceutical needs. When it comes to compounding special medicines, Artie Walker and his staff are there to serve you. And most importantly, if you need delivery, if you need curbside pickup, you need C&D Drugstore on the corner of B and Collars in downtown Russellville, a 60-year tradition.
Moving toward a 6 p.m. kickoff tonight at Thone Stadium at Burkle Field in Russellville. It is Family Day at Arkansas Tech University. And if you're not already on your way out to the stadium to cheer on the Wonder Boys tonight, we certainly hope that you'll start making your way that direction now. The opponent tonight is Ouachita Baptist, ranked number 6 this week in the American Football Coaches Association NCAA Division II National Top 25. And over those last 3 years, back to the start of the 2017 season, their overall record is 22-4. And Coach Shipp, as you've had a chance to work both here at Arkansas Tech and then at UAM and now back at Tech, you've prepared for every one of those Ouachita teams that's had so much success during this Great American Conference era. And one thing that has really always stood out to me about them is just how consistent they are in all phases of the game. What is it that makes them so steady, so consistent?
Well, they've got a great head coach. Todd Knight is the best head coach in our conference, in my opinion. Now, he's been doing it for 22 years, and so he's been allowed to get his formula down, and they execute it week in and week out. They're a team that's not going to beat themselves very often. They play great offensively, defensively, and special teams. And so if you don't meet their expectations from the other side, they're going to take advantage of you. And so tonight's a huge deal for us. A little bit test our manhood in a way, because they're a power football team on both sides, and we got to show up and show that we can play that power-style football for four quarters. And I think our kids are up to the challenge, but this is going to be a huge test versus a top-10 program in the country.
tackle really starts along that offensive line, and their ability to go out and run the football. They routinely just line up and knock folks down and kind of do what they want to do in the running game. And that, to me, makes the matchup of Washita's offensive line against your defensive front, if not the key matchup in this game, maybe one of the most important.
I agree completely with that. They do a great job coaching Mark Brett Shockley. Known him for a long time, GA'd here when I was playing, so I'll say part of that he got some from Ted, his toughness part, so he can contribute to that. But does a great job with that offensive line year in and year out. They're one of the best. And defensive line tonight is going to have to really step up and be able to hold their gaps, play with their heads, and not get out of gap assignments. If they do that, they'll at least let the linebackers have room to make plays, and we should be okay if we just play smart and play hard.
Are there any other key matchups from a position group against position group or otherwise that you really have your eye on going into tonight's game?
The offensive side, it's really our offensive line. How can we handle their defensive line? Because they have a good defensive line. How do we handle them? Can we hold line scrimmage and still run the football? Can we give our quarterbacks time to throw the football down the field? And so I think that's one. Also, they have a guy at Rally Freeman. He's got to be able to know where he's at all times. He's probably the best receiver coming back in our conference. Quick as a cat. I mean, he is kind of reminds me of an old Tracy Steiger, but a little bit faster. And so he's one from the defensive side. We've got to really watch him because he's a game changer.
We'll take a break and then come back for one more segment with Coach Schiff. This is Wonder Boys Football.
Your favorite meals from your favorite local restaurants have never been easier to eat, you guys, thanks to MyOrderOut. MyOrderOut.com is a food delivery service owned by Tyler Schumacher, and it is so easy. All you have to do is go online to MyOrderOut.com. Select Get Started Here, select a restaurant, and create your very own order. Then you can proceed to check out and enjoy the hot and delicious food delivered right to your door. Go to MyOrderOut.com to learn more.
How can I help you?
Can you turn on the porch light?
Sorry, I didn't get that.
Hey! Not every innovation is helpful, but the new ITMs at First State Bank can help you achieve your banking needs at the push of a button. Interact with local tellers, cash a check, and more, right from your car. Plus, ITMs are open these days from 7 to 7. To learn more about First State Bank's new innovative services, go to ffbitm.com.
For over 70 years, Old South Restaurant at 1330 East Main Street in Russellville has been faithfully serving the River Valley. Whether it's starting your day with a good old-fashioned breakfast or helping you make it through the workday with a hearty home-style lunch, and of course serving your family with a dinner that would even make your mama proud. Old South Restaurant on Main Street in Russellville. We're here for you.
We're here for you. Come on down.
Game visit. Best of luck tonight. coach of the Wonder Boys will step aside and then come back with more pregame. This is Arkansas Tech football.
Anytime online at CosmoMotors.com or come see us at 1900 East Main in Russell.
Maybe you're moving some dirt around the house, got jobs to do, things you need to get finished, and equipment to move. Well, maybe you don't have what you need. River Valley Tractor has it, and they have great prices and great people. Family owned and operated, they treat people like you would expect to treat family. Whatever you're looking for.
Stadium at Berkeley Field in Russellville. It's time for Arkansas Tech Wonder Boys football. Tonight, Arkansas Tech hosts the two-time defending Great American Conference champion Ouachita Baptist University Tigers here on River Country KCJC. Good evening, friends. My name is Sam Streisner. Thank you for joining us. Kelly Davis will be along in just a few minutes. Arkansas Tech is 0-1 following a season-opening 26-23 overtime loss at the University of Arkansas Monticello on September 5th. The Wonder Boys led 17-7 late in the second quarter, but a Bull Weaver rally culminated in Josh Marini's game-winning 23-yard field goal. Nationally 6th-ranked Ouachita Baptist began the pursuit of its third consecutive GAC title by topping Harding University 16-14 on September 5th. That game also came down to a field goal. Ouachita freshman Gabe Goodman provided the Tigers with their winning margin on a 38-yard field goal with just over a minute to play. It is a tall order here tonight for the Wonder Boys, but they have a family day crowd behind them and an opportunity to do something they've only achieved twice during the GAC era, cage the Ouachita Tigers. Thank you for joining us. We will break for 1 minute and then come back with the starting lineups. This is Wonder Boys football.
Hey guys, Terry Holland here at Best Drive. Did you know Best Drive's been in business for 15 years? We are still offering the same great customer service we started with in 2004. We started with an affordable car for 24 months or 24,000 mile service contract with a low interest rate. We helped with your sales tax and free insurance to the length of the contract and reported credit. Best Drive now offers a little more. We have a full service department with all your vehicle needs, a service contract with no deductible, and we are Lower Mountain for the Chiefs from Best Rock's been serving the River Valley for 15 years. You can find us at bestrockarkansas.com, Instagram, and Facebook. The Dodge MTH at 621 South Knoxville in Russellville.
Corey Beeson and the folks at Beeson Roofing Solutions are proud to support local sports in the River Valley. And they also want to say a special thank you to all their loyal customers and the community for their business. So if you have a problem with your roof, whether it be on your home or business, visit BeesonRoofing.com to see their work or call 967-2288 to schedule a free estimate or second opinion today from your local roofing experts, Beeson Roofing Solutions.
Back at Thone Stadium at Berkel Field in Russellville as Arkansas Tech head coach Kyle Shipp about to lead the Wonder Boys onto the field, marking the first time that an Arkansas Tech alumnus has led the Wonder Boys onto the field here at home since Leon Anderson did so back in 1979, his final season as the Arkansas Tech head coach. This is a special moment for Kyle, and it's a special moment for these young men under his leadership as they make their home debut here in the 105th season of Arkansas Tech football. Let's take a look at the starters first for our guests from the loveliest village on the Ouachita River, Arkadelphia, Arkansas, the Ouachita Baptist Tigers, led by head coach Todd Knight, who is in his 27th season as a head coach. His career record is 141, 127, and 2. This is his 21st season at Ouachita, and his record as the head coach in his alma mater is 113 and 95. He is a four-time Great American Conference Coach of the Year and a two-time Region Coach of the Year. Here are the starters for Ouachita. First, on the offensive side of the ball, the left tackle is Corey Gooseberry, 6'3", 290, senior, Little Rock. Peyton Stafford is at left guard, 6'3", 275. From Amarillo, Texas. The center is Jacob Roberts, 6'2", 295, a senior from Sherwood. And then on the right side of the Ouachita offensive line, the guard is Hunter Jackson, 6'3", 285, a sophomore from Ozark. And the tackle is Anthony Sherez, 6'6", 300, a sophomore from Sherwood. The tight end for the Tigers is Tyrell Robinson, 6'4", 250, junior, North Little Rock. The wide receivers are Allie Freeman, 5'9", 160, senior, Little Rock. Tucker Swoboda, 6'3", 175, freshman, Bentonville, and Justin Dean, 6'1", 190, sophomore, Mena. The running back is Shuncy Thomas, 5'9", 185, a senior from Bossier City, Louisiana, and the quarterback is Braden Brazil, 6'1", 190, a sophomore from England. Now the defensive starters for Ouachita, the defensive ends in a 4-3 alignment are Damian McDonald, 6'3", 245, junior, West Helena, and LaFoy Smith, 240, a senior from Warren. The interior defensive linemen for Ouachita are Zach Curry, 6'2", 285, senior, Madison, Tennessee, and Shamori Hampton, 6'2", 275, junior, Shreveport, Louisiana. The linebackers, John Johnson, 6'2", 230, senior, Haskell, Austin Guyman, 6'3", 210, junior, Little Rock, and Ty Compton, 5'10", 190, sophomore, Sherwood. The cornerbacks for the Tigers are Tyreek Harris, 6'2", 190, senior, England, and Keandre Evans, 5'11", 185, senior, Junction City. The safeties are Jonathan Harris, 5'11", 190, junior, Pine Bluff, and Hayden Lassiter, 6'2", 200, a junior out of Warren. And now the starters for the Arkansas Tech Wonder Boys, led by first-year head coach Kyle Shipp. On the offensive side of the ball, the left tackle is Cole Fritchin, 6'6", 322, a senior from Bryant. The left guard is Larry Clark, 6'4", 320, a sophomore from Blytheville. The center is Myron Henderson, 6'2", 280, junior, Memphis, Tennessee. The right guard is Christian Mayer, 6'5", 290, a junior from Muskogee, Oklahoma. And the right tackle is Jacob Reed, 6'4", 322, a junior from Russellville. The wide receivers for Arkansas Tech are Drew Wade, 5'8", 160, a junior from Pine Bluff, Trey Smith, 5'6", 160, junior from Springdale, and Brennan Lewis, 6'3", 200, freshman, Fort Smith. The tight end for the Wonder Boys is Tanner Gaines, 6'3", 225, junior, Hector. The running back is Caleb Beatty, 5'9", 210, junior, Foxworth, Mississippi, and the quarterback is Manny Harris, 6'2", 218, a senior from Copperas Cove, Texas. On the defensive side of the ball for the Wonder Boys, the defensive ends are DeAndre Dugan, 6'2", 230, sophomore, Sulphur Springs, Texas, and Carlos Gordon, 6'1", 264, junior, North Little Rock. The defensive tackles are Trey Chisholm, 5'11", 275, junior, Little Rock, and Kaylin North, 5'10", 275, sophomore, Dickinson, Texas. The linebackers for Arkansas Tech in a 4-2-5 alignment are Chris Kale, 6'3", 210, senior, Elkhart, Indiana, and Geo Williams, 6'1", 210. He is a junior from Denton, Texas, as is his twin brother, Dio Williams, 6'1", 188. Dio is a cornerback. The other starting cornerback for the Wonder Boys is Uriah Guy, 5'10", 180, sophomore out of Kansas City, Missouri. And then the safeties for Arkansas Tech are Adrian Scott. Adrian is 5'10", 175, a senior from Tunica, Mississippi, along with Dylan Kane, 5'10", 205, a senior from Houston, Texas, and Alex Chambers, 5'11", 165, a junior from Conway. Before we get the opening kick, we will pause 10 seconds for station identification. This is Arkansas Tech football. Washita Baptist won the opening toss and deferred its option until the second half, and so the Wonder Boys will receive the opening kick, and Arkansas Tech will be moving from our left to our right toward the south goal and the bandstand here in the opening quarter of play. It'll be Jake Ford to kick it away for Washita Baptist. Back deep to return for Arkansas Tech. On the far side, it's Drew Wade. And on the near side, it is Kendrell Johnson. Johnson, through 1 week, is fifth in the Great American Conference in kickoff return average at 21.3 yards per attempt. As we get set for the 84th all-time meeting between Arkansas Tech and Washita Baptist, the Wonder Boys lead this series 44-32 and 7 ties. Last season, Washita defeated Arkansas Tech 24-7 as the Tigers scored 14 points off turnovers in the final period of play to pull away for that victory. Keandre Evans and Hayden Lassiter both with fourth quarter interceptions in the win for the Tigers, and now Washita has won 6 out of the last 8 meetings in this series. The ball is teed up and we are ready for football at Thone Stadium at Merkle Field in Russellville. Glad that you are with us here on River Country, KCJC, and ArkansasTechSports.com. The opening kick is away. It'll come down to Kendrell Johnson, a yard deep. He's going to bring it out. Drew Wade blocking in front after the 15 to 20. Bounces it to his left and is tackled at the 21-yard line is Kendrell Johnson. There with the special team stop for Washita, it is Keandre Evans, and Arkansas Tech will begin 1st and 10 from its own 21-yard line. The Wonder Boys had 368 yards of total offense 9 days ago in the season opener at UA Monticello. Arkansas Tech's offense really buoyed that night by its running attack. Arkansas Tech had 225 rushing yards against the Bull Weevils, and that was an average of 4.9 yards per carry. Arkansas Tech second in the GAC in rushing offense through 1 week of the season. Manny Harris is the quarterback. Caleb Beatty joins him in the backfield. Two receivers left, one to the right. The starting halfback is going to be Tucker Kennedy. He goes to the left side of the formation. Hand off to Beatty. Beatty tries the middle and is wrapped up at the point of attack. Slicing through, getting through his block and making that stop for Washita Baptist. It was Damian McDonald coming over from his defensive end spot. McDonald, 6'3", 245, a junior out of West Helena, makes the stop for no gain. And it is second down and 10, Arkansas Tech from its own 21-yard line. Two receivers left, one receiver near the formation on the right side. Handoff is going to go around the left end to Deion Simmons, the freshman out of Mayflower. He will get 1 yard up to the 22. There with the stop for Washita, it was John Johnson, senior linebacker. It's third down and 9 for Arkansas Tech. Third downs were not kind to the Arkansas Tech offense in week 1. The Wonder Boys just 1 of 14 on third down conversions against UA Monticello. Three receivers right, two to the left here on third down and 9. Manny Harris will be alone in the backfield as he prepares to receive the snap from center Myron Henderson. Snap is on its way. Here comes the pressure. Wonder Boys do a good job picking it up. Pass is complete into the near flat. Tackled short of the first down marker is the receiver, Brennan Lewis for Arkansas Tech. He was stopped by DeAndre Evans at the 29-yard line. Following a gain of 7, it brings up 4th down and 2, and Tyler Dunlop will check in to punt for the first time. Dunlop in his second year as the Wonder Boys punter. So far in his career, he has punted 68 times for 2,805 yards. That is an average of 41.3 yards per punt for his career. Last week at UA Monticello, he averaged 39.3 yards per attempt. Bit of a low snap. Dunlop takes it on one hop. Fortunately for the Wonder Boys, no pressure on the kick. Fair catch called for and made by Ouachita's Allie Freeman at the 38-yard line. The kick by Tyler Dunlop travels 33 yards, and we've got timeout on the field. 13:02 to go, first quarter. Arkansas Tech and Ouachita Baptist are scoreless. We'll break for 1 minute. You're listening to the Wonder Boys.
How many times have you had to go without your heating or your air unit when you needed it most? Your family's freezing or sweating, and they look to you for relief. You call someone, and they say it's going to cost an arm and a leg to fix. Do you really feel like you have a choice? Well, now you do. Call Tony at Arkansas River Valley Heating and Air at 479-964-4004 for a free second opinion from a guy you can trust to take care of you and your family and get that unit running without all the extra charges. Arkansas River Valley Heating and Air. Bellmer's Athletes Corner, your high-performance athletic store for quality athletic footwear and apparel, features Nike, Under Armour, The North Face, Patagonia, Oakley, Saucony, New Balance, Brooks, Asics, Kabu, Keen, and many, many more. Bellmer's invites you to make them your first stop. With more than 50 years combined experience, the familiar faces at Bellmer's can help you with all your athletic needs. Bellmer's Athletes Corner, 2320 West Main, Russellville, open 9:30 until 6, Monday through Saturday.
Braden Brazil leads the Ouachita Baptist offense onto the field. The Tigers, after a season-opening win 16-14 over Harding, go on offense for the first time here in Week 2. Wonder Boys in their standard 4-2-5 alignment defensively. Handoff is to Shuncy Thomas. He tries the left side and gains 2 yards up to the 40. Among the Wonder Boys there on the stop was Gio Williams, junior linebacker out of Denton, Texas. They're going to give him the 41-yard line for a gain of 3, and so it'll be 2nd down and 7 for Ouachita from there. The Tigers, against that very good Harding defense, had just 266 yards of total offense in their season opener. Brazil brings a man in motion. It is Shuncy Thomas who will now join him in the backfield. Takes a handoff to him, passing the near flat complete to Allie Freeman. Freeman is forced out of bounds at the 45-yard line after what would have been a gain of 4, but there are penalty flags down on the play. And so we will wait to see the nature of the foul before we find out whether or not that play will stand. Here comes the referee to let us know. He is going to indicate holding against Ouachita, so that will wipe out most, if not all, of that game. We'll see from what spot they enforce the penalty. They're going to say it happened at or behind the line of scrimmage, though. It'll be the full 10 yards back to the 31-yard line. At least that was the initial indication. Now they're just going to say the foul occurred at the 44-yard line and mark it off from there. So they got 3 yards before the penalty occurred. And they spot the football at the 34-yard line, and from there it'll be 2nd down and 14. Braden Brazil brings a man in motion. It's Hunter Swoboda, brother of the aforementioned Tucker Swoboda. They both play wide receiver for the Tigers. Brazil rolls the pocket to his right, throws for Allie Freeman. Freeman makes the catch, forced out of bounds by Arkansas Tech's Adrian Scott at the 41-yard line. The play goes for a gain of 7, and it'll be 3rd down and 7 for the Ouachita Tigers from their own 41-yard line. Allie Freeman was by far Braden Brazil's favorite target in Week 1. Freeman made 11 catches against Harding, and that was tied for the most for any receiver at the NCAA Division II level in Week 1 of the 2019 season. 4 receivers, 2 to either side for Brazil on 3rd down and 7. He takes the snap, has time, throws deep down the far sideline looking for Freeman. Double coverage, overthrows him, incomplete. Alex Chambers and Darren Kane there with the pressure for Arkansas Tech. And the incomplete pass will make it 4th down and 7, and the two sides exchange 3 outs on their first possessions of the night here at Thone Stadium at Berkeley Field in Russellville. Tyrus Fort back deep to return the punt, which will be made by Jake Ford of Ouachita Baptist. Ford leads the GAC in punting early this year at 46.5 yards per attempt. Arkansas Tech's Tyrus Fort waits at his own 11-yard line. Line of scrimmage is the Ouachita 41 on 4th down and 7. Punt is away. Not his best effort. Ford will come up and make a running grab on a fair catch at the 23-yard line. And so that punt for Ford only travels 36 yards. And we will have timeout on the field. 11:33 to go in the opening quarter. Ouachita Baptist and Arkansas Tech are scoreless. We will pause for 1 minute. This is Wonder Boys Football.
Hey, it's Drew Mitchell for Lakeside Oral, Facial, and Dental Implant Surgery. Lakeside is really proud this year to be sponsoring our local sports all throughout the River Valley. They're committed to the area. It's just another way they show that. When you're in the market for dentures, wisdom teeth, or whatever the case may be, remember Lakeside Oral, Facial, and Dental Implant Surgery. And check out their website at lakesideofs.com. Lakeside Oral Surgery, helping make the broadcast of local sports throughout the River Valley possible.
Joshua's Fine Jewelry, a luxury establishment in the heart of downtown Russellville, are taking it back to the good old days with a family-owned, family-operated business that pride themselves on personal interactions, beautiful custom craftsmanship, and an insanely knowledgeable and helpful staff that go above and beyond just for you. Joshua's Fine Jewelry is giving a huge shout-out to all of our local River Valley and Natural State athletes. You guys are the real MVPs. Be sure to like Joshua's Fine Jewelry on Facebook today and go and give him a visit in downtown Russellville at 310 West Main Street.
Come on, y'all.
Crank it up.
River Country, KCJC.
So the defenses have had the upper hand early on here tonight at Thone Stadium at Berkeley Field. Both offenses going 3 and out on their first possessions of the night. Now the Wonder Boys go on offense for the second time. Option play right. Manny here at Harris pitches it out to Deion Simmons, and he's tackled at the 26-yard line. Damian McDonald with the stop for Ouachita Baptist. The gain on the play for Arkansas Tech will be 3, and it'll be 2nd down and 7 for the Wonder Boys from their own 26-yard line. Manny Harris coming into the night, completing 89 of 184 career passes as a Wonder Boy. He has 916 career passing yards at Arkansas Tech and 3 career passing touchdowns. The senior from Copperas Cove, Texas, fakes a handoff, throws across the middle. It is incomplete off the arms of his intended receiver. Coming across the middle for Arkansas Tech, it was Trey Smith, broken up for Ouachita by Jonathan Harris. And the incomplete pass will make it 3rd down and 7 for Arkansas Tech from its own 26-yard line. The receivers to the left side of the formation on 3rd down will be Trey Smith and Drew Wade. 2 more receivers to the near side of the field for Arkansas Tech. One of them now goes in motion. That's Devin Alloway. He goes over into the wide side of the field. Wonder Boys moving from our left to our right. Pass down the middle. Catch is made. All the way up to the Arkansas Tech 49. Reception made by that man who went in motion, Devin Alloway. And he has a gain to the 49-yard line, a pickup of 23 on 3rd down and 7. And the Wonder Boys have the first down of the game. Correction, make that a gain of 22 to the 48-yard line. That's where they end up spotting the football. Nonetheless, it's a big plenty for an Arkansas Tech first down as Manny Harris brings the Wonder Boys back to the line of scrimmage. 2 receivers left. Handoff to Caleb Beatty, and he is wrapped up in the backfield. And once again, it is that man for Ouachita, Damian McDonald, who so far has been unblockable coming from the left defensive end spot for Ouachita Baptist. Beatty stopped at the 48-yard line for no gain. It'll be 2nd down and 10, Arkansas Tech from there. And it is clear that Ouachita, at least early on, is committing the personnel necessary to stop the run. They're going to force the Wonder Boys to beat them with the pass. Manny Harris fakes a handoff, throws to the near side, catch made by Brennan Lewis. Lewis drags one defender down the near sideline, and he drags that defender, Tyreek Harris, out of bounds at the Ouachita 47 with a gain of 5. It'll be 3rd down and 5 from there for the Wonder Boys. Arkansas Tech wearing gold pants and green uniform tops, white numbers and letters outlined in gold. The gold helmets
with the AT logo on one side and each player's jersey number on the other. Third down and 5, Manny Harris calls for the snap, makes the handoff. It's a quarterback keeper. Harris runs right. Harris will have the first down inside the Washita 40-yard line, and down to the 35 he goes. Gain on the play of 12 yards on the quarterback keeper as the Wonder Boys convert on back-to-back third down opportunities. They just cashed in more third downs than they did all of week one when they had just one third down conversion, and right now the Wonder Boys on the move, first and 10 at the Tiger 35-yard line. Manny Harris doing a great job reading the Washita defense, found the open space. It was to the right side of the formation, and away he went. Man comes in motion. That's Brennan Lewis. Option play left. He pitches it to Lewis. Does Manny Harris? Lewis around left end. He'll be upended at the 30-yard line. The gain on the play will be 5. Tackle made for Washita Baptist by Jonathan Harris. And it will be second down and 5 for the Wonder Boys from the Washita 30-yard line. Checking in for Arkansas Tech at a receiver spot, it'll be Trey Smith. He replaces Devin Allaway. Smith and Dion Senegal are the receivers to the right side of the formation for Arkansas Tech. Manny Harris calls for the football, receives the snap, hands it off. Running right is Dion Simmons, and he runs headlong into Hunter White. At the Washita 28-yard line, it'll be a gain of 2. And it'll be third down and 3 for the Wonder Boys. They need to get to the Tigers' 25-yard line in order to pick up the first down. Tanner Gaines checks in. He will be either a halfback or a tight end to the left side of the formation. Tucker Kennedy, the other halfback, stays in the game. Gaines will line up as a tight end this time. Kennedy halfback to the right side. The running back for Arkansas Tech is Wallace Foote. He gets the carry, Foote between the tackles, and down to the 25. He needed 3, and 3 is what he got. Another third down conversion for Arkansas Tech. It's third of this drive, and it is first down and 10 at the Washita 25-yard line with 7 minutes and 40 seconds to go in a scoreless first quarter here at Thone Stadium at Burkle Field in Russellville. The play call to his teammates. Two receivers left, one to the right. Harris takes the snap, fakes a handoff, throws across the middle. It is just beyond the fingertips of Dion Senegal, who had beaten his man at the 5-yard line, but the throw just a bit too tall for even Dion Senegal to reel it in. Senegal stands 6'3" and could not quite get his fingertips to that football. And so the incompletion will make it second down and 10 for Arkansas Tech. And the line of scrimmage will remain the Washita 25. Harris will have one receiver to his left, two to his right. On second down and 10, 7 minutes and 21 seconds to play first quarter. Man in motion, whistles, and let's see what we have. I don't immediately spot a penalty flag. It's Washita that wants timeout. 7:20 to go, first quarter, no score. Let's pause for 1 minute. This is Wonder Boys football. At Thone Stadium at Burkle Field. Second down and 10, Wonder Boys. Pass is incomplete. And it'll be third down and 10 now for the Wonder Boys. There will be two receivers to the right side of the formation and one to the left after that incompletion. 7 minutes and 17 seconds to go in the first quarter. No score between the Wonder Boys and the Tigers.
Harris, the Arkansas Tech quarterback. Checks to the near sideline. Now Harris pitches out wide right for Wallace Foote. Foote surrounded by three Wichita defenders, spins out of that and gets all the way down to the 17-yard line. Wallace Foote got about eight more yards than perhaps he should have there, as three Wichita defenders had him dead to rights at the 25. But he's able to spin down to the 17. That'll make it fourth down and two. And now Jesus Zazumbo, who was a perfect 3-for-3 on field goal attempts a week ago, will have a 34-yard try from the right hash mark out of a hole by Landon Smith. Placement is down. Kick is away. It is good, and our new score. 6:36 to go in the first quarter is Arkansas Tech 3, nationally 6th-ranked Wichita 0. Here at the Bone Stadium at Merkle Field, we will pause for 30 seconds. This is Arkansas Tech football. The scoring drive for Arkansas Tech, 13 plays, 60 yards. It took 4 minutes and 57 seconds. And the 34-yard field goal by Jesus Zazumbo, making him now 4 out of 4 on field goal attempts this season. And now Zazumbo will kick it back to the Wichita Tigers with a bit of a breeze at his back. He's going to go with the sky kick, though, toward the near boundary. Fair catch called for and made by Wichita's T.J. Cole. Inside the 30-yard line, some pushing and shoving after the play. A penalty flag is thrown. Wonder Boys are clapping, believing that it will likely be against Wichita, but we'll wait and see until the man in the white hat lets us know. 2 officials talking it over. Good strategy there by the Wonder Boys to go with the sky kick and eliminate any chance of a return by Allie Freeman. The personal foul is against Arkansas Tech for unsportsmanlike conduct. And so that will add 15 yards onto the end of that play. And the football, as a result, instead of being placed at the 31-yard line, it'll be placed at the 46. So a big difference there in terms of starting field position for Wichita. And we'll see if the Arkansas Tech defense can positively respond to this adversity. Hand off to Brockton Brown, and this is not the response we were looking for. Brown through the right side of the offensive line, and he will go all the way to the end zone. It is a 54-yard touchdown run for Brockton Brown. Brown is a senior from Sheridan, 5'10", 195, and he bursts through the right side of the offensive line and goes 54 yards for his second rushing touchdown of the season. And it took all of 10 seconds for Wichita to erase the Wonder Boys' lead and take the Tigers' first advantage of the night. Gabe Goodman will attempt the extra point. Out of a hold by Jake Ford, the kick is away, it is good. And our new score with 6:26 to play in the first quarter is Wichita Baptist 7 and Arkansas Tech 3. We will pause for 30 seconds. This is Wonder Boys football. One play, 54-yard scoring drive that took 10 seconds. The 54-yard touchdown run by Brockton Brown. That is the longest run so far this season by a Wichita Tiger. It is also the longest run allowed by Arkansas Tech so far this year. And
it'll be Jake Ford to kick it back to the Wonder Boys. Kendrell Johnson and Drew Wade back deep for Arkansas Tech. With Ouachita now leading 7-3 here at the 6:26 mark of the opening quarter. Kick is away. Kendrell Johnson will field it at the goal line. Four blockers in front, comes out to the 10, the 15, and is going to be swarmed there. Taken down at the 17-yard line is Kendrell Johnson. Primary stop made for Ouachita Baptist by C.J. Heckard. Terrell Gibson also in on that stop. And it'll be first down and 10 for the Wonder Boys from their own 17-yard line. The last drive for the Wonder Boys was a very good one. Arkansas Tech able to take the football and drive all the way into the red zone before being forced to settle for the field goal try. A change at quarterback for the Wonder Boys. Carter Burcham is going to run the offense on this set of downs. He's got two receivers to his left. Pistol formation. Turns, fakes the handoff to Beatty. Burcham runs around left end, being forced toward the boundary, and he'll be forced out of bounds by C.J. Heckard at the 24-yard line. A positive play, though, as Burcham able to turn it upfield at the last moment and get out of bounds at the 24-yard line with a gain of 7. And that makes it second down and 3 for Arkansas Tech. Burcham was actually the Wonder Boys' leading returning rusher from a year ago from the quarterback position. Of course, Brian Allen got the lion's share of the carries a year ago, but after him, the second leading rusher a year ago was Burcham. Man in motion, Drew Wade. Fakes the handoff to Beatty, got an option play right, and he'll be stopped at the 25-yard line, Will Burcham. Tackled there by Hunter White. Gain on the play is 1, and it'll be 3rd down and 2 for the Wonder Boys. Arkansas Tech has been good so far tonight on 3rd downs, 3 out of 5. Including 3 3rd down conversions during that drive that led to the 34-yard field goal by Jesus Zazumbo. 5:31 to go, first quarter. Ouachita 7, Arkansas Tech 3, from Thone Stadium at Vertical Field in Russellville. Two receivers left. Burcham brings a man in motion from the shotgun, takes the snap. Burcham wanted to throw, now he'll tuck it and run, and he will have the first down, stopped at the 29-yard line by Ouachita Baptist's Austin Guyman and John Johnson. But the pickup of 4 yards on 3rd down and 2 moves the chains once again. The Wonder Boys have their 4th first down of the game, and it's 1st and 10 Tech at its own 29-yard line. Carter Burcham proving again to be a weapon with his feet here since entering the game for the first time this season. He hands it off to Caleb Beatty. Beatty turns it upfield between the tackles and will gain 1 yard to the 30, where he was surely wrapped up and taken to the turf by John Johnson. It'll be 2nd down and 9, Arkansas Tech from its own 30-yard line. Trey Smith checks in at wide receiver for the Wonder Boys, as does Caleb. Well, Caleb Stokes looked like he was going to check in. Now he's called back at the last instant. Trey Smith and Deion Senegal will be the receivers to the left side of the formation. Drew Wade is the receiver right. Carter Burcham checks to the near sideline for the play call. They've got the one they like. Burcham throws, complete to Gaines out in the far flat. Gaines pursued, 1 missed tackle, and then he's forced out of bounds by Heckard and Hunter White. They force him out at the 34-yard line. Gain on the play is 4. That makes it 3rd down and 5. One of the things that Coach Shipp mentioned during the pregame interview is the fact that the Wonder Boys had little success on 3rd down last week, in large part because of what they did not do on 1st and 2nd down. The Wonder Boys have done a much better job tonight of getting themselves into manageable 3rd down situations, and that's why they're 4 out of 6 in that scenario so far tonight, as compared to 1 out of 14 against UA Monticello. Man in motion is Devin Allaway. Burcham takes the snap. Burcham wants to run straight ahead, and he'll be wrapped up and taken down. Stop made for Ouachita Baptist by LaFoy Smith and Damian McDonald, as the two defensive ends combining to make that stop at the 33-yard line. Loss of 1 on the play, and it will be 4th down and 6 for the Wonder Boys. And for the second time tonight, Arkansas Tech will call upon the talents of Tyler Dunlop. Dunlop's first punt of the evening traveled 33 yards. He's got a bit of a breeze at his back here. If he could turn one over, he could kick it a long way. He has the snap. It is perfect. Punt is away. It'll be fielded at the 29-yard line by Allie Freeman, and he is immediately grabbed around the ankle and taken down by Adrian Scott. Excellent punt coverage there by Arkansas Tech's Adrian Scott to take away any opportunity for a return. Freeman spotted down at his own 28-yard line. It is a punt of 39 yards for Tyler Dunlop. And Ouachita gets the football back with its 7-3 lead intact. And now 3 minutes and 21 seconds remaining in our first quarter. Glad you are with us tonight here on River Country KCJC. This is one of six Great American Conference games being played tonight. We'll get you score updates as the evening unfolds. Braden Brazil hands it off to Shuncy Thomas on first down. He never had a chance. Met in the hole by Arkansas Tech's Chris Kale, the senior linebacker out of Elkhart, Indiana. Comes up and records his 91st career tackle as a Wonder Boy. Making the stop at the 27-yard line for a loss of one. It'll be second down and 11. Kale coming into the night had two career tackles for a loss. Adds to that total here. Braden Brazil on second down and 11 brings a man in motion. It's Allie Freeman. Brazil takes the snap. Brazil, plenty of time, throws across the middle, complete to Freeman. Freeman, blocker in front, over the 40, the 45, up to midfield goes Allie Freeman, and he's taken down there. Darren Kane makes the tackle for Arkansas Tech, but the play for Ouachita will go for a gain of 25 to the Arkansas Tech 47-yard line, and that's an example of the danger of the speed of Allie Freeman and what he can do once he gets his hands on the football. It's a first down, Ouachita at the Tech 47, 2:23 to go first quarter. Tigers with the ball and a 7-3 lead. Brazil in a pistol formation with Shuncy Thomas behind him. He gives to Thomas. Thomas runs left, and there's Chris Kale to make the stop again for Arkansas Tech. Tackle made at the Arkansas Tech 44-yard line. Gain of 3 for Shuncy Thomas. And it'll be second down and 7, Ouachita from there. Tigers will get Jack Pillow, their fullback, out of the game, and replace him with wide receiver Hayden Waller. Here on second down and 7 from the Tech 44. Braden Brazil with two receivers to his left, two to his right, waits in a shotgun formation. Brazil takes the snap. He wanted to set up a screen pass to the near side, but penalty flags at the beginning of the play stop the action. And it is a false start against Ouachita. That will move the football back to the 49-yard line of Arkansas Tech. And from there, it'll be second down and 12 for the Tigers. Hope you'll make plans to join us again next Saturday evening. We will be down in Arkadelphia to take on the other GAC member from that community, Henderson State University. Planning for a 6 p.m. kickoff next Saturday night at Carpenter Haygood Stadium. That means pregame coverage will start at 5:30. Here on River Country, KCJC, and ArkansasTechSports.com. Shuncy Thomas shifts to join Brazil in the backfield. Brazil sweeps it out to him on the right side. Shuncy Thomas forced out of bounds inside the 45-yard line. Now, they say he stepped out right at the 45, so not as much gain as it first appeared there. Only a gain of 4 to the Arkansas Tech 45-yard line. And from there, it'll be third down and 8 for the Tigers as we get 1 minute to play in the first quarter. And on the defensive line now for Arkansas Tech, Josh Little. He's manning one of the interior spots. Arian Banks has checked in at a defensive end. The two defensive ends will stand here for Tech on third down and 8. Brazil takes the snap. Braden Brazil throws it toward the near side. Allie Freeman makes a leaping grab at the 25. Tackled immediately by DeAndre Irvin, but it will go for a gain of 20 yards and another third down conversion for the Ouachita Tigers on a fabulous leaping grab by Allie Freeman at the Arkansas Tech 25-yard line. And from there, it'll be first down and 10 for Ouachita. Tigers make some personnel changes after the first down. Tucker Swoboda is back in at wide receiver. He's joined on the right side of the formation by Hayden Waller. Brazil hands it off on first down. Straight ahead running for Ouachita's T.J. Cole, and he takes it inside the 20 down to the 16-yard line. A pickup of 9 for Cole on his first carry of the season. And it'll be second down and 1 for the Tigers. Line of scrimmage is the Arkansas Tech 16.
Brockton Brown, who had that 54-yard touchdown run earlier in the quarter, checks in. And he will be the running back on the first play of the second quarter. 15 minutes in the books at Thone Stadium at Berkeley Field in Russellville, where our score is Ouachita Baptist 7, Arkansas Tech 3. We will pause for 30 seconds. This is Arkansas Tech football.
The proud supporter of the Arkansas Tech Wonder Boys and Golden Sons. For all of your financial service needs, contact Scott Langley at your local Russellville Raymond game.
It is our honor to once again be joined on the broadcasts this season by a member of the Arkansas Tech University Hall of Distinction, a Wonder Boy All-American, the Director of Alumni Relations at Arkansas Tech, and all-around good guy, Mr. Kelly Davis. Kelly, all I can say about Family Day, and in particular the tailgating that we had before the game, is wow. We've got a lot of members of the Arkansas Tech family here today.
Absolutely, and we sure appreciate everybody coming out. We know it's a warm day, but the whole week has been wonderful. Paint the town green and gold. We had March to Maine on Thursday, then a pep rally Thursday night downtown at the Depot, and then all the events. Activities today for Family Day and then the game tonight. It's been a great, great week.
As we begin the second quarter, it is second down and one for Ouachita Baptist at the Arkansas Tech 16-yard line. Tigers leading 7-3. Brockton Brown is going to take a direct snap here. He fumbles it. Ball is loose at the 20. He's able to fall on it. Brockton Brown recovers his own fumble. Trey Chisholm there to make sure he couldn't get back up and run with it. But it'll be down at the 20-yard line, a loss of 4 on the fumbled snap. And now it'll be 3rd down and 5. Both of these teams struggled in the red zone in terms of being able to score touchdowns a week ago. Ouachita advanced into the red zone 5 times against Harding, but they only came away with 1 touchdown out of those 5 opportunities. And we'll see if the Wonder Boys defense can continue that trend here by stopping the Tigers on 3rd down. It's 3rd and 5 from the Wonder Boys 20. Arkansas Tech shows a middle blitz. Braden Brazil takes the snap. Wonder Boys back off. No blitz coming. Brazil will run with it, and he lowers his head to get the first down. He ducks his way over the 15-yard line and down to the 14. A pickup of 6 on 3rd down and 5, and that was nothing but some good old-fashioned toughness from Braden Brazil.
There was. He knew exactly where he needed to go to reach that first down marker, and he dove right for it.
1st and 10, Tigers at the Arkansas Tech 14-yard line, pistol formation. Braden Brazil, the quarterback. Shuncy Thomas is the running back for Ouachita. 2 receivers left. Brazil throws that direction. Allie Freeman makes the catch to the 10, to the 5. He dives for the pylon, and he is in. Touchdown, Ouachita Baptist, on a 14-yard pass to Allie Freeman over on the far side, as Ouachita ran a pick play to perfection there. There was a Wonder Boy defender that was about to break on the football and possibly intercept it when a Ouachita receiver collided with him while the ball was still in the air, and that prevented any chance of an interception and enabled the 14-yard touchdown pass to Allie Freeman. Gabe Goodman tries the extra point. It is up. It is good, and our new score at the 13:43 mark of the second quarter is Ouachita Baptist 14, Arkansas Tech 3. Let's pause for 1 minute. You're listening to the Wonder Boys. With you here at Thone Stadium at Berkeley Field in Russellville. The scoring drive for Ouachita was 9 plays, 72 yards. It took 4 minutes and 38 seconds, resulting in the 14-yard touchdown pass from Braden Brazil to Allie Freeman. For Brazil, the touchdown pass was his first of the season. Allie Freeman with his first touchdown reception of 2019. And as a result, Ouachita Baptist bat along with the Gabe Goodman extra point. The Tigers now lead 14-3. And for the first time tonight, Jake Ford of Ouachita will have a chance to kick off with the wind at his back, although the wind not quite as much a factor now as it was earlier. Drew Wade and Kendrell Johnson back deep for the Wonder Boys. Ford sends it on its way. It is hooking toward the far boundary, and it will go out of bounds. As a result, Arkansas Tech will get to start first down and 10 from its own 35-yard line. And Kelly, when you're the kicker and the kickoff goes out of bounds, you take a little bit of extra time going back to retrieve your tee to head to the sideline, don't you?
Yes, you do. And then as you get that tee, you look and see where the coaches are and you go the other direction.
Life is all about strategy.
Strategy. Exactly. But, you know, eventually they find you.
They do. You cannot hide. First and 10 for the Wonder Boys from their own 35-yard line. Arkansas Tech now moving from our right to our left. We gave you the jersey combination for Arkansas Tech. Ouachita tonight wearing white uniform pants and white uniform tops with purple letters and numbers. They have the purple helmets with the Ouachita Tiger logo on one side.
End of the first quarter, it's Harding 14, UA Monticello 0.
Manny Harris on a quarterback keeper faked a screen pass out of the near flat, tried to set that up, and then tried to run it straight ahead, and that did not work out. There to stop it for Ouachita was Anthony Freeman. And the tackle made at the 34-yard line, so it's a loss of one on the Manny Harris quarterback keeper. Manny Harris and Carter Burcham have split time so far tonight at quarterback for Arkansas Tech. Wallace Foote back in at running back. Wallace, in the season opener for the Wonder Boys, had 9 carries for 67 yards, an average of 7.4 yards per carry. Pass complete to the far side of the field to Brennan Lewis. Lewis forced out of bounds at the Arkansas Tech 38-yard line, a pickup of 4 on the play. And it'll be 3rd down and 7 for the Wonder Boys. Arkansas Tech is 4 out of 7 on 3rd down conversions so far this evening. 12 minutes and 51 seconds to play in the second quarter. Ouachita Baptist 14, Arkansas Tech 3. 4 wide receivers for Harris, 2 to either side. Line of scrimmage is the Tech 38. Harris steps up in the pocket and down he goes. Quarterback sack back at the 35-yard line. Recorded for Ouachita Baptist by Damian McDonald, who has been a man possessed here so far tonight for the Tigers. He makes the tackle at the 35 for a loss of 3, and the Wonder Boys go 3 and out, unable to take advantage of the good field position set up by the kickoff out of bounds. Tyler Dunlop on to punt it away. Dunlop so far tonight has averaged 36 yards per punt on 2 attempts. Has the snap, takes his time, and gets the kick away.
Good punt.
Allie Freeman makes a running grab at his own 26-yard line, brings it toward the near boundary, and is forced out of bounds at the 35. Special team stop made for Alex Chambers of Arkansas Tech. And it'll be 1st and 10, Ouachita, from its own 35-yard line when we come back. 11:53 to go, second quarter. Tigers lead 14-3. We will pause for 1 minute. This is Arkansas Tech football. 11 minutes and 53 seconds to go in the second quarter. Ouachita Baptist with the ball and a 14-3 lead. Braden Brazil hands it off to Brockton Brown. Brown tries the middle. And Desmond Williams is there to let him know it was a bad idea. Desmond Williams there to plug the hole. A redshirt freshman defensive tackle out of Rockwall, Texas. 6'1", 290 makes the tackle.
He plugged that hole very quickly.
Gain of two. And it'll be second down and eight for Ouachita from its own 37-yard line.
Henderson State 6, Southern Nazarene 6 in the second quarter.
Brazil from the shotgun, two receivers left, two to the right. Sets up a screen to the near side. It is complete to Kamontre McKnight, his first catch of the night. And it won't go for much. He's wrapped up and taken down. There with the defense for Arkansas Tech. It was Uriah Guy, sophomore defensive back, making the stop at the 36-yard line.
Well, he lunged forward, but apparently he already had a knee on the ground and for a no gain.
Ended up marking it down for a loss of one, back to the 36. And so it'll be third down and nine from there. Ouachita is 2 out of 3 on third down conversion tries so far tonight. 10:44 to go, second quarter. Ouachita 14, Arkansas Tech 3 on Family Day 2019 here at ATU.
Yeah, big third down right here.
Braden Brazil has time, lobs it deep down the near boundary. Penalty flags fly. And let's see what we got. The intended receiver was Justin Dean. The pass went incomplete. Now we'll wait and see what the penalty flags are indicative of.
Well, if they're calling holding, then they need to call that both ways.
We'll see what the referee has to say. He has the word from his colleagues. It is indeed holding against Arkansas Tech, and so that'll be a free first down for the Tigers. It will move the football up to the Ouachita 46-yard line. And the Tigers have their 7th first down of the game as compared to 4 for Arkansas Tech. The Tigers sitting at 145 yards of total offense thus far. Arkansas Tech with 84 yards of total offense as we play early in the second quarter. Good news for the Wonder Boys is the offense has been balanced. 42 passing yards, 42 rushing yards. First down and 10, Tigers from their own 46. Brazil takes a handoff, quarterback keeper around left end. Saw nothing was there as the Wonder Boys had him contained on the outside, so he just lowers his right shoulder and ducks to get what he can.
Hey, it was all covered. Covered the running back and the quarterback. Good job.
And what he could was 1 yard. Actually, a correction.
No gain. Zero.
No gain on the play. 46. And so it'll be second down and 10. Excellent job there by the right side of the defensive line for Arkansas Tech, including Derek Albers, who had the outside contain, and then George Brooks, who helped get him to the turf. So no gain on the quarterback keeper for Braden Brazil, and it's second down and 10 for the Tigers from their own 46. Brazil takes the snap, rolls to his left. He is going to run for it. Spin move, makes one man miss, and then Brazil tumbles down at midfield, a pickup of 4 on the quarterback keeper. And it'll be third down and 6 for Ouachita from the 50-yard line.
Third down and 6.
Clock rolling, 9.5 minutes to go in the second quarter. Want to pass along a thank you to everyone who attended the big Family Day Band and Choir concert earlier this afternoon at Tucker Coliseum. Second annual event, and I think that's going to be a staple of the Family Day schedule.
Oh, well, that was awesome. I attended that, and they did a wonderful job.
Third down and 6. Brazil, under some pressure, unloads to far side, leaping try. Did he get a foot down inbounds? Two officials converge, and they say he did not. The intended receiver was Tucker Swoboda, and he gave his very best effort to catch the football and get a toe down inbounds.
A lot of pressure on the quarterback that time. That's what you need.
Adrian Scott hit Braden Brazil just as he let go of that football and helped force that incompletion. And so now on fourth down and 6, the Tigers will be compelled to punt it away. Jake Ford is the Ouachita puncher. His first punt of the night traveled 36 yards, which is well shy of what had been his season average of 46.5 yards per punt. Tyrus Fort waits at the 10-yard line for Arkansas Tech. Ford has the snap. The punt is away. It is a high end-over-end kick. And the fair catch is called for and made by Arkansas Tech's Tyrus Fort at the 11-yard line. And it was a punt of 39 yards.
Looked like a kickoff.
It did. And the Wonder Boys will have their worst starting field position of the night, forced to begin from their own 11-yard line. I'll pass along congratulations to our colleagues over in the Division of Enrollment Management and really everybody at Arkansas Tech University for what was a banner year in recruiting freshmen here on the Russellville campus. Arkansas Tech with 1,726 freshmen this year. That is a new record. Also a new record for freshman enrollment on the Ozark campus and a new record for freshman enrollment overall at Arkansas Tech University. And so a big congratulations to everybody who contributed to that and bringing in a great group of freshmen this fall. Manny Harris is the quarterback for Arkansas Tech on this set of downs. And on first down and 10 from his own 11-yard line, he hands it off to Caleb Beatty. Beatty runs right and gets a couple out to the 13-yard line. Among the Ouachita Tigers there to make the stop were Clark Yarborough. And also there for Ouachita, it was LaFoy Smith. Gain on the play is 2. It is second down and 8 for Arkansas Tech from its own 13-yard line. Caleb Beatty remains the running back. And the quarterback is Manny Harris. Harris fakes a handoff. Harris wants to throw, lobs it toward the near side, has a man, catches made over the 30-yard line. It's Drew Wade out of bounds with the reception. They will mark him out at the Arkansas Tech 37-yard line. The gain on the play is 24, and the Wonder Boys have their fifth first down of the night. And Kelly, nice touch on that pass
that was
by
perfect.
Manny Harris.
Perfect timing, great throw. Drew Wade, 5'8", 170. Junior out of Watson Chapel in Pine Bluff.
Deion Senegal and Drew Wade are the receivers to the right side of the formation into the wide side of the field. Hand off Caleb Beatty. He bobbled it for a moment, but then gathered the football. Wrapped up by Rico Gonzalez at the 40-yard line. Pickup of 3 for Arkansas Tech, and it'll be second down and 7 from the Wonder Boys 40-yard line. 7 minutes and 41 seconds to go, second quarter. Ouachita Baptist on a 54-yard touchdown run by Brockton Brown and a 14-yard touchdown pass from Braden Brazil to Allie Freeman leads it 14-3. The Wonder Boys points coming on a 34-yard field goal by Jesus Zazumbo. Senegal in motion. Hand off to Beatty. He runs up the middle, bounces off the first man, stays on his feet, and should have enough for Arkansas Tech first down up to the 47-yard line.
Tough run.
Gain of 7 for Caleb Beatty, the transfer from Missouri Southern State University. And it'll be first and 10 Wonder Boys from their own 47.
5'9", 210. That is exactly almost the same size as one Emmett Smith played for the Cowboys.
That low center of gravity.
Low center of gravity.
It works. One receiver right, two to the left. Ball spotted between the hash marks. Wonder Boys moving from our right to our left toward the north goal and the hole building. Harris fakes short, wants to throw.
Oh, he is wide.
He's got Wade all over the 20-yard line. Wade makes the catch, and there he goes. Touchdown, Arkansas Tech on a 53-yard strike from Manny Harris to Drew Wade.
What a pass route. He had the Ouachita player frozen and got behind him. Great throw, great run.
It is a Phil Wright Autoplex Wonder Boys touchdown with a 53-yard pass from Manny Harris to Drew Wade as the Ouachita secondary bit on the fake when Manny Harris delivered the pump fake, and then all he had to do was put enough air under it to get it to Drew Wade, and that is exactly what he did. Now Jesus Zazumbo to try the extra point. It is on its way. It is good, and our new score with 6:42 to go in the second quarter is Ouachita 14, Arkansas Tech 10. We will pause for 30 seconds. This is Wonder Boys football. So the poorer starting field position proved to be no problem for the Wonder Boys. A 5-play, 89-yard scoring drive that took 2 minutes and 17 seconds, highlighted by 2 long completions from Manny Harris to Drew Wade, the last of which was a 53-yard touchdown pass. And now Jesus Zazumbo to kick it back to the Tigers. With the Ouachita lead trimmed to 14-10, just past the midpoint of the second quarter. End-over-end kick will come down to Allie Freeman at the 14-yard line. He's out over the 20, the 25 with 3 blockers in front.
He's to the 30. He's got a convoy to the 40 and spun down at the 41-yard line following a kickoff return of some 25 yards. It was Allie Freeman, and the Tigers will get to start from their own 41 with 6:33 to play until halftime.
I vote we don't kick it to him anymore.
No, he is a dangerous man. He came into the night tied for second in the conference in all-purpose yards this season after gaining 165 all-purpose yards in the season opener.
He just does a very good job of following his blockers.
Braden Brazil, the quarterback, he's joined in the backfield by T.J. Cole. Screen pass complete to the far side of the field. Receiver makes one man miss into Arkansas Tech territory now, and all the way down to the Wonder Boys 45 goes T.J. Cole out of the backfield, making that reception for a gain on the play of 14 yards, and Ouachita has its eighth first down of the game.
Sam, it's a given. All wide receivers are going to hold defenders. You just have to fight through it and get away from them.
And sometimes they're going to set a pick and get away with it.
And sometimes they do that, too.
As we learned earlier in the game. 6 minutes to go in the second quarter. Ouachita leading 14-10. Braden Brazil fakes a handoff. He fakes short, throws deep, has a man wide open, and the Ouachita Tigers have given the Wonder Boys a dose of their own medicine as Brazil that time, just like Manny Harris a moment ago, faked short, threw deep, and it was as easy a touchdown as Tucker Swoboda will score in his life. As he reeled it in all alone in the secondary and takes it in for a 45-yard touchdown reception from Braden Brazil.
I think all you can say is busted coverage.
Ouachita making a habit of quickly answering Arkansas Tech scores here tonight. They only needed 10 seconds to respond the first time the Wonder Boys scored. This time they needed 48 seconds to respond. The extra point by Gabe Goodman is good. And our new score with 5:54 to go in the second quarter is Ouachita 21, Arkansas Tech 10. We will pause for 30 seconds. This is Wonder Boys football. The scoring drive for Ouachita Baptist, two plays, 60 yards. It took 39 seconds on two Braden Brazil completed passes, the last of which was a 45-yard touchdown pass to Tucker Swoboda. Brazil's second touchdown pass of the night and the season. Swoboda gets his first touchdown reception of his collegiate career, the freshman from Bentonville. And it's 21-10 Ouachita. The ensuing kickoff by Jake Ford is into the end zone for a touchback, and it'll be first and 10 Wonder Boys from their own 25.
Excellent kickoff.
Put a boot into that.
He did. Makes up for that out of bounds one.
It does. Like, might have got some motivation after that.
See, when he got the tee that time, he ran straight for the coach.
What a difference.
Makes a difference.
What a difference one kick can make, yes. The Arkansas Tech offense back onto the field, led by Manny Harris.
Just got to keep matching them.
Harris will be joined in the backfield by Wallace Foote. What a story Wallace Foote is. Played for the Wonder Boys as a freshman in 2013 out of Benton High School. Had been out of collegiate football, out of school for 6 years before coming back this fall. And now is about a 24-year-old sophomore. He takes the handoff from Manny Harris. He never had a chance. Ouachita won the battle up front that time. And again, it was Damian McDonald with the tackle, and that's going to compel me to move over to the official stats. Damian McDonald from a defensive end spot, which is not typically a spot that's supposed to rack up a lot of tackles. That's now six tackles already tonight for Damian McDonald, four of which have been of the solo variety. Checking in a wide receiver for Arkansas Tech, it'll be Dion Senegal. He and Drew Wade will go to the far side of the formation, into the wide side of the field. Quarterback Manny Harris brings Drew Wade in motion. Harris drops back to pass, under pressure, rolls to his right. Now he unloads. It is caught by Wade right at the first down stick.
Should be first down.
He makes the grab at the 35-yard line. It is a gain of 10, and it is enough for the eighth first down of the night for the Wonder Boys. First and 10 at the Tech 35 as we go under 5 minutes to play in the second quarter with Ouachita Baptist leading 21-10. The
The Tigers come in having won 18 consecutive Great American Conference games. It is the second longest winning streak in conference games in the history of the league, which dates back to 2011. Manny Harris fakes a handoff, throws it deep down the far boundary. It is caught! Caught by Dion Senegal as he was striding down the far sideline. He was pushed out of bounds at the Ouachita 32-yard line. It is a pickup of 33-yard line, and the freshman Dion Senegal shows us a flash of his athleticism there, providing the Wonder Boys with a deep threat that they just really didn't have a year ago. And now penalty flags before the snap and a false start as the Wonder Boys trying to go fast there. Called for a false start. Head coach Kyle Shipp out on the field looking for a little more explanation as to exactly what the Wonder Boys did wrong. The referee says the Wonder Boys were never set. Coach Shipp disagrees. As part of the no-huddle, hurry-up offense is occasionally the ability to go fast, and the Wonder Boys tried to do just that there, and the officials did not feel like they got set. So it'll be first and 15. The new line of scrimmage is the Ouachita 37. Manny Harris wants his halfback Tucker Kennedy to the left side of the formation, so that's where he goes. Harris fakes the handoff and gets clobbered. Quarterback Keeper and LaFoy Smith there to make the tackle for Ouachita. Smith wears number 42 for the Tigers. He's out of Warren, Arkansas. And the former Lumberjack makes a tackle at the 38-yard line for a loss of one. It'll be second down and 16 for the Wonder Boys. They know how to grow them down in Warren, don't they, Kelly?
Yes, they do. They produce some very good football players in Warren, Arkansas. They're having a good year this year as well.
Two receivers left. Dree Wade, one of those, comes in motion. Now Harris fakes a handoff. Harris has some time, looking to throw. Rolls to his right, throws. It is going to be incomplete, I hope. The Ouachita defensive back caught it, but he was out of bounds when he did so. Making a diving attempt to intercept it was Andrew Hayes, a freshman defensive back out of Bryant. And he did indeed catch the football, but he was out of bounds when he did so. This Ouachita defense intercepted three passes last week against Harding, and now some activity that suggests maybe we might have a penalty on the play as well. Yeah, there's the flag now. I see it back behind the line of scrimmage. It's holding against Arkansas Tech.
Got to call it both ways, gentlemen.
Kind of a tough decision there for Coach Todd Knight. Do you want third down and 16 or do you want second and 26? He elects to accept the penalty and moves the Wonder Boys back to the Ouachita 48-yard line. But as a result, the Wonder Boys get to keep the down. It's second down and 26.
Let's see if we can make that decision incorrect.
Three receivers left, two to the right. Manny Harris alone in the backfield on second down and 26. Man in motion, Devin Alloway. Alloway goes to the far side of the field. Harris takes the snap. Harris throws short and complete. Reception made by Alloway, and he'll be spun down by three Ouachita defenders after a short gain. Leading the search for the Tigers was John Johnson. The play will go for a gain of three, and it will bring up third down and 23 for the Wonder Boys. Arkansas Tech is 4 out of 8 on third down conversions tonight, but third down and 23 is not what you're looking for. That penalty a moment ago against Arkansas Tech was the fourth of the game against the Wonder Boys for 44 yards. Ouachita has been penalized twice for 15 yards. Tigers were the least penalized team in the league in week one. Pass complete from Manny Harris to Deion Simmons. Simmons down the far sideline will be forced out of bounds at the 28-yard line.
Decision time.
It will be a 45-yard field goal from there. Zazumbo was good from 47 yards a week ago, and he'll get a try at it here. A 45-yard try from the right hash mark. Bit of a breeze into his face, kicking toward the north goalpost and the hole building. Here at Thone Stadium, the Burkle Field in Russellville, trying to make this a one-possession game late in the second quarter. If you're thinking ahead to the second half, the Ouachita Tigers will get the football first to begin the third quarter of play. The 45-yard field goal try by Zazumbo is on its way. It'll be long enough, and it is good.
A lot of distance.
Hey, Zeus Zazumbo improves to 5 out of 5 on field goal tries this season, and our new score with a minute 48 to go in the second quarter is Ouachita 21, Arkansas Tech 13. Let's pause for 30 seconds plus a station ID. This is Wonder Boys Football.
Number 95, Aces Zabuto, will kick off for Arkansas Tech.
The scoring drive for Arkansas Tech, 7 plays, 47 yards. It took 4 minutes and 6 seconds, resulting in the 45-yard field goal by Jesus Zazumbo. His ensuing kickoff is just barely going to go out of bounds. He very nearly angled it inside the pylon for a touchback, but it goes out of bounds inside the 5-yard line. And as a result, Ouachita will get to start first and 10 from its own 35 here with a minute 48 to go in the second quarter. And the Ouachita lead now cut to 21-13 following the long field goal by Jesus Zazumbo. And what a turnaround story for the sophomore from Springdale, who was just 2 out of 8 on field goal attempts a year ago. This season, he is 5 out of 5 so far. And Kelly, as you know as well as anyone, kicking is so much confidence, and right now Zazumbo has a lot of it.
A lot of confidence and a lot of timing, but if you can get a slump, you got to get out of it real fast.
A flinch along the Ouachita offensive line should result in a false start against the Tigers, and it will. And that'll cost them 5 yards back to their own 30. From there, it'll be first down and 15 for Ouachita. Ouachita with 209 yards of total offense here in the first half, compared to 235 for Arkansas Tech. Two teams have both accumulated 9 first downs so far. Wonder Boys have had possession for over 18 minutes compared to just about 10 minutes for Ouachita. Of course, the Tigers' propensity for big plays contributing to that.
Main thing right here, don't give up an easy score right before halftime.
Brazil hands it off. T.J. Cole, the ball carrier. And he goes straight ahead over the 35 up to the 36-yard line. Gain of 6 on the play. It'll be second down and 9 for the Tigers from their own 36.
Not sure why the officials were stopping the clock. I guess they thought it was a first down.
Well, Trey Chisholm lost his helmet for the
ball. Oh, gotcha. Okay.
Giving him a chance to check out may have been it. Braden Brazil in the shotgun formation on second down and 8, we'll call it. Complete pass near side for Allie Freeman. Freeman is wrapped up over the 40-yard line. Tackle made for Arkansas Tech by Chris Kale. He's got him down at the 43-yard line after a gain of 6.
There's that holding again that we talked about by the wideouts. You have to be able to fight through and get away from them. They're not going to call it.
Third down and 2. You know what they say, Kelly? Cop didn't see it, I didn't do it.
That's right.
Third down and 2, quarterback keeper for Brazil, and he's going to be stopped short of the yard to gain. Tackle made for Arkansas Tech by George Brooks.
What to do? Going to call timeout.
The sophomore out of Allen, Texas, with the tackle, a yard short of the line to gain. And it'll be fourth down and 1 for the Tigers from their own 44. Arkansas Tech calls timeout. We will take a 30-second break with them. This is Wonder Boys Football. Seconds remaining in the second quarter. Ouachita leading 21-13. The Tigers have sent out Jake Ford to punt it away on fourth down and 1.
Well, you won the bet.
As I told you during the break, you don't get to be a head coach for 27 years by going for it on fourth and 1 from your own 44.
Well, you can make a mistake every now and then.
You're not going to make one here. The Tigers will punt it away. Ford's kick is in the air.
Oh, nice punt.
Kind of a sidewinder. Tyrus Fort calls for and makes a fair catch at his own 15-yard line. Todd Knight electing not to take a chance there right before halftime.
Two timeouts left, Sam. Think we try to get a score. Let's do it.
Oh, I think especially, I think the thing you got to factor in here is the fact that Ouachita is going to get the football to begin the third quarter. I think that may cause the Wonder Boys to be a little more aggressive.
I thought we deferred to the second half.
Now, Ouachita won and deferred, yep. Yep.
I tried.
You were busy with the banner down there during the
game. Well, I was.
You got a lot of things going right there before kickoff.
Oh, well. Sorry about that.
A lot of things on old KD's mind right now.
I got everybody so pumped up and then poked a hole in the balloon.
That's okay. Manny, that's what you do best. Manny Harris in the shotgun on first down and 10 from his own 15-yard line. Two receivers to his right, one to his left. Man in motion. Harris fakes a handoff. Harris is going to throw. He's got a lot of time. Rolling to his right. Now under pressure. Just going to have to throw it away. There to provide the pressure and force Harris to throw it away was John Johnson.
There was definitely no doubt he was outside the tackle.
Yes, he was safe of any chance of an intentional grounding call there. Is checking in for the Wonder Boys will be Tanner Gaines replacing Tucker Kennedy. Kennedy kind of grasping at his left hand there. Hope he's okay.
Yeah, Ouachita has two timeouts as well.
Wallace Foote is in at running back. Two receivers right, one to the left. Man in motion is Trey Smith. Handoff is to Foote. Foote between the tackles up to the 20-yard line. He'll have 5 yards. And Ouachita Baptist will use one of those timeouts. 29 seconds to go, second quarter. Tigers lead 21-13. Let's break for 30 seconds. This is Arkansas Tech football. Seconds to go in the second quarter. Ouachita Baptist 21, Arkansas Tech 13. Hope you'll stay with us at halftime. We will bring you the halftime performance by the Arkansas Tech University Marching Band, known far and wide for generations as Arkansas's Band of Distinction. Band did a neat thing the other day. It would have been the 100th birthday of the late Gene Witherspoon, who was the director of bands here for 29 years, and the band spelled out Chief 100 during their practice the other day and got some aerial photos of it from Ryan Taylor from the Marcom staff here at Tech. Straight ahead running for Wallace Foote on third down and 5. He gets it out to the 25-yard line for a gain of 5. It's enough to pick up the first down, and so Ouachita now will cease with the practice of using timeouts. We'll see if the Wonder Boys even want to run another play here, if they just want to get to the locker room, regroup, and get ready for the third quarter. Wonder Boys are going to go up to the line of scrimmage. They're at least going to make Ouachita stay on the field for the full length of the half if they don't run a play here. 4 seconds left in the half. Manny Harris brings a man in motion. 1 second. They snap it. Harris gives to Wallace Foote. Foote runs left and is tackled after a gain of 4. Stop made for Ouachita by Keandre Evans. And that is how the first half comes to an end. And so far, the Wonder Boys are going toe-to-toe with the number 6 ranked team in the country. The score at halftime is Ouachita Baptist 21 and Arkansas Tech 13. We will step aside for a 3-minute break and then come back with the halftime show. This is Wonder Boys Football. halftime at Bone Stadium at Burkle Field in Russellville, and our score is Ouachita Baptist University 21 and Arkansas Tech University 13 here on Family Day on the Arkansas Tech campus. We are certainly glad that you are with us on River Country, KCJC, and ArkansasTechSports.com. It has been a busy family day at Arkansas Tech University, and much of it has included musical performances from our instrumental and our vocal musicians here at Arkansas Tech. The day began this morning at Chambers Cafeteria with a performance by the Arkansas Tech Jazz Ensemble, as well as the Arkansas Tech Music Theater Workshop. And then this afternoon, the aforementioned concert that the choirs and the bands here at Arkansas Tech performed. And now the day about to continue with a halftime performance by the Arkansas Tech University Marching Band, Arkansas's Band of Distinction. Let's take a look at the halftime numbers before the band takes the field. So far for Arkansas Tech, the Wonder Boys have 67 rushing yards and 182 passing yards for 249 yards of total offense. Ouachita with 89 rushing yards and 134 passing yards. That's 223 yards of total offense for Ouachita. The Wonder Boys have had the football for almost 19 minutes compared to 11 minutes for Ouachita Baptist Tech, 5 out of 10 on third down conversions compared to 2 out of 5 for the Ouachita Tigers. So far, there have not been any turnovers in the game. Ouachita fumbled it once, but was able to recover that fumble. And so no turnovers as of yet in the ball game. And both teams are 1 out of 1 on red zone scoring opportunities. Individual leaders for Arkansas Tech: Wallace Foote, 7 carries for 27 yards. Manny Harris has completed 10 of 14 passes for 178 yards and a touchdown. Drew Wade with 3 catches for 87 yards and a touchdown for the Wonder Boys. Tech led defensively by Chris Cale. For Ouachita, Brockton Brown has 3 carries for 52 yards. Braden Brazil has completed 9 of 11 passes for 134 yards and 2 touchdowns. Allie Freeman, 6 catches for 75 yards. And defensively, Hunter White and John Johnson have 6 tackles apiece for Ouachita. Now we will turn down my microphone, turn up the crowd mic, and allow you to enjoy the halftime performance by the Arkansas Tech Marching Band, Arkansas's Band of Distinction. Listening to the halftime performance by the Arkansas Tech Marching Band under the direction of Dr. Daniel Belongia and Dr. Jim Daughters. The voice of the Arkansas Tech Band is Dr. John Clements. performance by the Arkansas Tech University Marching Band, Arkansas's Band of Distinction. Our score at halftime is Ouachita Baptist 21 and Arkansas Tech 13. We will pause for 3 minutes, and when we return, Kelly Davis will get us up to date on the GAC scoreboard. This is Arkansas Tech football. It is halftime in Russellville, and Ouachita Baptist, ranked number 6 in the country at the NCAA Division II level, leads Arkansas Tech by a score of 21-13. And here with a look at what else is going on this evening in Great American Conference football is one Kelly Davis.
Thank you, Sam. All these were 6 o'clock kickoffs. We have 3 halftime scores besides ours. Harding University, 24. UA Monticello, 0. It is Henderson State, 27, Southern Nazarene, 6. Southern Arkansas, in a battle with Oklahoma Baptist, it is 17-14, Southern Arkansas at the half. And two that are still completing the first half, we have Southeast Oklahoma with a 10-9 lead over Northwest Oklahoma. And Southwest Oklahoma, all over East Central, it is 24-7, about 3 minutes to go before halftime in Weatherford. And that's all I've got.
Coming up here in the next week or so, several events on the Arkansas Tech University campus of note. A couple I wanted to mention in particular while we had a moment here at the halftime break. One is coming up on Thursday, September 19th. So this coming Thursday, Andrea Gonzalez Caballero, an award-winning international performer from Spain, will perform the 2019 John and Trudy Watson Classical Guitar Series concert Here at Arkansas Tech on Thursday, the performance will begin at 7:30 p.m. Thursday in Witherspoon Auditorium, 407 West Q Street here in Russellville. Admission will be free and open to the public. Caballero became the youngest champion of the Alhambra International Guitar Competition when she captured first place in the Valencia, Spain event in 2016. She has also won first place in an international guitar competition in Rome, Italy. An Opera World magazine has described her as the female voice of the Spanish guitar. She is currently pursuing a performance diploma, a graduate performance diploma, at the Peabody Institute of Johns Hopkins University in Baltimore, Maryland. And we certainly thank Dr. John W. Watson, distinguished professor of mathematics and former vice president for academic affairs at Arkansas Tech, as well as his wife, Trudy, for sponsoring the annual Watson Classical Guitar Series. And again, that event coming up Thursday night at 7:30 in Witherspoon Auditorium, admission free and open to the public. Another musical event hosted by Arkansas Tech University coming up within the next week will be the Brass in the Clouds event. That annual activity will take place next Saturday evening. It will begin up on Mount Nebo at 6:30 p.m. at Sunset Point. The public is invited to attend. Brass chamber ensembles and the Arkansas Tech Brass Choir will perform under the direction of Arkansas Tech Department of Music faculty members Dr. Sean Reed and Dr. T.J. Perry, as well as Clayton Maddox and Evan Mino, visiting lecturers of music here at ATU. Mount Nebo State Park recommends that audience members bring blankets or chairs for seating comfort. It's the 2019 Brass in the Clouds concert next Saturday night at 6:30 at Mount Nebo's Sunset Point. You can read more about both of those events and so much more at ArkansasTechNews.com. Halftime at Thone Stadium at Burkle Field. It's Ouachita Baptist 21 and Arkansas Tech 13. We will pause for 3 minutes and then come back with a look at what else is going on in Arkansas Tech athletics. This is Wonder Boys Football. with you at Thone Stadium at Burkle Field in Russellville, where it is halftime and nationally sixth-ranked Ouachita Baptist has a 21-13 lead over Arkansas Tech. Let's take a look at what else is going on in Arkansas Tech athletics, and it has been a great day for the Golden Suns volleyball team. Today, competing up in Kearney, Nebraska, the Golden Suns defeated the University of Mary and New Mexico Highlands, defeating Mary 3-1, and then a sweep 3-0 over New Mexico Highlands. And so a two-match winning streak for the Golden Suns as they get set to open conference play on Tuesday in Searcy against Harding University. That will be a 6 p.m. match on Tuesday. You'll be able to follow live coverage of that match at ArkansasTechSports.com. Next weekend, the Golden Suns volleyball team will venture to Evansville, Indiana, where head coach Kara Dukic's team will compete in a tournament hosted by Southern Indiana. They'll play four matches up there, and then finally, after 13 consecutive matches away from home to begin the year, the Golden Suns will make their home debut on Tuesday, September 24th, against Southern Arkansas University. First serve at Tucker Coliseum on the 24th will be at 6 p.m. Other upcoming events in Arkansas Tech athletics, the Golden Suns cross-country team idle this weekend. They will run next weekend in the Missouri Southern Stampede in Joplin. The Wonder Boys golf team opens its 2019-2020 season this coming Monday and Tuesday at the Northeastern State University Invitational. That'll be at Muskogee Country Club in Muskogee, Oklahoma. And then a week later, on September 23rd and 24th, the Golden Suns golf team will begin its 2019-2020 season by competing in the Dallas Baptist Invitational. Learn more about what's happening in Arkansas Tech athletics at ArkansasTechSports.com. We will pause for 30 seconds and then be back to get the second half underway. Ouachita leads 21-13. This is Arkansas Tech football. Back with you and ready to get the third quarter underway here at Thone Stadium at Burkle Field in Russellville, with Ouachita Baptist leading Arkansas Tech by a score of 21-13. In this home debut for the 105th season of Arkansas Tech University football, we are certainly glad to have you along for the ride here on River Country KCJC and Arkansas Tech Sports. Back deep for Ouachita, it's Allie Freeman on the near sideline. Don't really want to kick it to him. Over on the far sideline, it is Darius Hopkins. And Jesus Zazumbo will kick it away for the Wonder Boys as we begin the second half here on Family Day 2019 at Arkansas Tech University. Zazumbo, the sophomore from Springdale, is going to go with an onside kick here. It bounces off the Ouachita return man, C.J. Heckard. The Wonder Boys dive on it. They say they have it. The official waiting to say. The Wonder Boys pretty sure they have the football, and the main reason they are is because they came out of the pile with it, recovering the loose ball for Arkansas Tech. It was Denzel Washington, junior defensive back out of Monroe, Louisiana, recovering the onside kick as Zazumbo just angled it on a line drive right at C.J. Heckard. He was not ready for it, caught him flat-footed, and the Wonder Boys recover an onside kick to begin the third quarter. You've got to take a few chances to pull off an upset. Coach Shipp taking one there, and it pays off for the Wonder Boys. Now let's see if the offense can go cash it in. What a way to start the second half for Arkansas Tech. Two receivers right, one to the left. Manny Harris wants to throw, rolls to his right, throws short and complete. It's not going to go for much. The reception made for Arkansas Tech over on the far side of the field by Brennan Lewis. And he was immediately met by two Ouachita Tigers, foremost among them Andrew Hayes. And Lewis is tackled at the 49-yard line of Arkansas Tech for a gain of one. It'll be second down and nine for the Wonder Boys.
Manny Harris in the shotgun, flanked by two setbacks. Hard snap count. Now he gets the football. Throws across the middle behind his intended receiver, incomplete. He was looking once again for Brennan Lewis. Coverage provided for Ouachita by Andrew Hayes and John Johnson. And now the incomplete pass makes it third down and nine for the Wonder Boys from their own 49. Deion Simmons, one of those two running backs, checks out, replaced by wide receiver Devin Alloway. Alloway will be out wide to the left along with Drew Wade and with Trey Smith. One receiver to the right side of the formation as Manny Harris awaits the snap on third down and nine. He has it. Good protection. Harris throws to the far side of the field. Catch is made for an Arkansas Tech first down. Making the grab near the boundary was out of the backfield, Caleb Beatty. Beatty spun down the 40-yard line of Ouachita. The gain on the play is 11 yards, and it is the 11th first down of the night for Arkansas Tech. New line of scrimmage is the Ouachita 40 on first down and 10. 13:55 to go third quarter. Ouachita leads 21-13, but Arkansas Tech trying to seize the momentum here by recovering an onside kick to begin the second half. Pass from Manny Harris was really high over the far side of the field. Brennan Lewis, using his lanky frame to leap and make the grab, comes down to a seated position with the football at the 35-yard line of Ouachita. It is a gain of five, and it'll be second down and five for Arkansas Tech. Two receivers right, one to the left. The lone setback is Caleb Beatty. Manny Harris gives to him. Beatty runs left, bounces off one defender, and then is taken down by Austin Guyman. They've got Beatty marked down at the 34-yard line, a gain of one, and it'll be third down and four for Arkansas Tech. Just over 13 minutes to play, third quarter. Ouachita leads 21-13. The Tigers trying to pick up their 19th consecutive win in GAC play. The Wonder Boys trying to jumpstart their rebuild with a win over a top 10 ranked team. Manny Harris throws complete to Drew Wade. Flanker screen to the near side, and Wade is wrapped up and taken down shortly thereafter by Hunter White. Tackle made at the Ouachita 32. It's a gain of two. It's fourth down and two. Neither side has gone for it on fourth down yet tonight, but I think that's about to change. The Wonder Boys, 9 days ago in the season opener, were 2-for-2 on fourth down conversion tries. This will be a fourth and two from the Ouachita 32. Checking in up front as an extra blocker is Noah Reyes, 6'3", 255 out of Boonville. Now it's going to be in the shotgun formation. Tanner Gaines taking the direct snap. Gaines runs left. He's stacked up for a loss. Stays on his feet for a moment, but then the majority of the Ouachita defense arrives to stop him for a loss of two. First man there for Ouachita Baptist was no surprise, Damian McDonald. And they've stopped Gaines for a loss of two on fourth down and two, and Ouachita Baptist will take over on downs. Tigers simply won the battle up front that time, and Gaines never had a chance. So it'll be first and 10 Ouachita from its own 34. And with 11:59 to go in the third quarter, the Tigers get the football back with their 21-13 lead over Arkansas Tech still intact. Pistol formation. Braden Brazil, the quarterback. Shuncy Thomas is the running back. Man in motion is Hunter Swoboda. He goes to the left side of the formation. Now Shuncy Thomas shifts over to the left side, takes the handoff. Thomas around right end, forced out of bounds. Penalty flag flies. There to force the ball carrier Thomas out of bounds was Arkansas Tech's Uriah Guy. He stepped out of bounds along about the 37-yard line, but we've got a penalty flag back at the 35 in a spot where you had anticipated holding against the offense. And if that's what you anticipated, you'd be correct. They will enforce that from the spot of the foul, which was the 35-yard line. So it goes for a run of 1 yard for Shuncy Thomas, and then a 10-yard penalty back to the 25. And from there, it'll be first down and 19 for Ouachita Baptist. Braden Brazil, the Ouachita quarterback, came into the night fifth in the nation in completion percentage, and he's done nothing to harm his numbers in that category. He's 9 out of 11 passing tonight. He will throw again here, has a man wide open, the 40. Catch is made by Hunter Swoboda. Swoboda off to the races. Allie Freeman there to block for him, and Swoboda will go inside the 5 and into the end zone. Touchdown. touchdown, Ouachita Baptist, on a 75-yard pass from Braden Brazil to Hunter Swoboda. And Ouachita Baptist has now scored touchdowns tonight on plays of 54, 53, 45, and 75 yards. It's been all about the big play tonight for the Tigers. And now the extra point will be attempted by Gabe Goodman. Comes with 11:34 to go in the third quarter. Goodman is 3 for 3 on extra point tries so far tonight. The left footer kicks this one through the uprights, and our new score with 11:34 to play in the third quarter is Ouachita 28, Arkansas Tech 13. We will pause for 1 minute. This is Wonder Boys Football. To go, third quarter. Ouachita now leads 28-13 following a two-play, 66-yard scoring drive that took 25 seconds. A 75-yard touchdown pass from Braden Brazil to Hunter Swoboda, and then the extra point by Gabe Goodman giving the Tigers a 28-13 lead. Jake Ford's kickoff. Fair catch is called for and made at the 5-yard line by Arkansas Tech's Kendrell Johnson. That will bring the football out to the 25-yard line. And the Wonder Boys will go back on offense in need of a scoring drive. Now trailing by 15 here early in the third quarter. That need really kind of created by the huge momentum swing that we've already seen here in the first 3.5 minutes of this half. The Wonder Boys trying to grab that momentum by recovering an onside kick to begin the third quarter. But then that drive stalled inside the 35-yard line of Ouachita. Two plays later, the Tigers are celebrating a touchdown. Wallace Foote is in at running back for Arkansas Tech. Manny Harris, the quarterback. Harris in the shotgun. Takes the snap. Fakes, or gives to Foote, I should say. Foote goes up the middle and able to push the pile forward out to the 28-yard line. A gain of 3 for Wallace Foote. Among the Ouachita Tigers there to make the stop, Tommy Crumpton, along with Rico Gonzalez, as some second stringers in some spots right now on the defensive side for Ouachita. Jamerick Waller is in on the defensive line. Second down and 7, Arkansas Tech, 11:05 to go third quarter. Ouachita leading 28-13. Manny Harris fakes the handoff, quarterback keeper around left end, and he'll be stopped at about the 34-yard line. Tackle for Ouachita Baptist by Rico Gonzalez and Austin Guyman. Stop made at the 33-yard line. So the play goes for a gain of 5, and it'll be 3rd down and 2 for the Wonder Boys. Arkansas Tech, 6 out of 12 on 3rd down conversions tonight, a drastic improvement over week 1. On 3rd and 2, Manny Harris will go under center for the first time tonight. He hands it off to Wallace Foote. Foote tries to go up the middle, and he's going to be stopped. It appears short of the yard to gain. First contact made defensively by Austin Guyman. Foote unable to get to the 35. He needed 2 yards. He got just 1, and now Tyler Dunlop will come out to punt it away for Arkansas Tech. Dunlop has punted 3 times tonight for an average of 37.3 yards per punt. Back deep for the Ouachita Tigers, waiting at his own 30-yard line, it is Allie Freeman, who has also at different times played basketball for Ouachita Baptist University. Dunlop's punt is away. Fair catch called for and made at the Ouachita Baptist 34-yard line. So so it is a punt of 32 yards, and there's timeout on the field. 9:43 to go in the third quarter. Ouachita leads 28-13. Let's pause for 1 minute. This is Arkansas Tech football. Ouachita Baptist begins its second possession of the second half, first and 10 from its own 34-yard line. Braden Brazil is the quarterback. Pistol formation with Shuncy Thomas behind him. Two receivers right, open field to the left for the Ouachita Tigers. Wonder Boys in their 4-2-5 defensive alignment. Pitch to Shuncy Thomas. He fumbles it. Able to dive on the loose ball back at the 27-yard line. Second time tonight. The Tigers have put the football on the ground both times. They've been able to scramble to recover. This one will go for a loss of 7. And it'll be second down and 17. Some uncharacteristic, unforced errors in this one by the Tigers. But yet they lead 28-13. 9 minutes and 17 seconds to go in the third quarter, as Ouachita seeks its 19th consecutive win in conference play. Braden Brazil hands it off to Brockton Brown. Well blocked around left end. Brown is upended as he reaches the 35-yard line. Tackle made for Arkansas Tech by Alex Chambers, the Conway product who attended Morrilton High School. Stop made at the 35-yard line. From there, it'll be third down and 9 for Ouachita Baptist, following a gain of 8 for Brockton Brown. Brown, now with 4 carries for 60 yards tonight. He's averaging 15 yards per carry, helped along by one run of 54 yards. On third down and 9, Braden Brazil wants to throw, lobs it deep down the near side. It is going to be incomplete as the receiver, Allie Freeman, ran out of bounds of his own volition, and so he had no chance to make that play anyway. It was expertly covered by DeAndra Irvin, and the incomplete pass will force Ouachita Baptist into a punting situation. The fourth punt of the night for Jake Ford. His first 3 punts have averaged 38.7 yards per attempt. Tyrus Fort will set up shop at his own 25-yard line. Line of scrimmage is the Ouachita 35. As Jake Ford gets set to punt it away. Ford is originally from Shepparton, Australia, 6'2", 225, a senior. Previously attended the University of Oregon. Beautiful punt here. Sends Tyrus Fort scrambling back to his own 17-yard line, where he makes a fair catch following a 48-yard punt. 8:21 to go in the third quarter. Ouachita Baptist leading 28-13. The Wonder Boys will go back on offense, albeit with less than ideal starting field position, thanks to the best punt of the night by Jake Ford. Arkansas Tech so far tonight with 276 yards of total offense. 201 of those have been of the passing variety, as Ouachita has really loaded the box and forced the Wonder Boys to beat them with the pass. Several times, the Wonder Boys have been successful in that endeavor. Manny Harris, 14 of 19 for 197 yards and a touchdown. Harris hands it off here on first down, straight ahead running. And the first carry of the season for Christian Cole, sophomore running back for Arkansas Tech out of Soxie, Texas. Missed the first game of the season due to injury, but back in there for the Wonder Boys tonight. And his first carry of the season results in a gain of 2 to
to the 19-yard line of Arkansas Tech. It'll be second down and 8 for the Wonder Boys. Cole remains in the game as the running back. A pair of Texans in the backfield right now for Arkansas Tech. Copperas Cove product Manny Harris fakes the handoff. Harris rolling to his right under a heavy rush. Harris will head for the boundary, and he'll be forced out of bounds by Andrew Hayes. They will spot him out of bounds at the 19 as he was able to scramble for no gain, and it'll be third down and 8 for the Wonder Boys. Good job there by Harris, really just to avoid the sack. Wide receivers for Tech on third down and 8. Drew Wade and Trey Smith to the left side of the formation. Tucker Kennedy is in the game as a halfback. And then the lone receiver to the right side is Brennan Lewis, the redshirt freshman transfer from the University of Memphis. Harris takes the snap. Harris steps up in the pocket, throws short and incomplete in and out of the hands of Christian Cole. Cole was being pursued by two Ouachita Tigers. He would have had to have done something spectacular to reach the yard to gain anyway, even if he had made the catch. The drop assures the Wonder Boys are in a punting situation on fourth down and 8 from their own 19. 7 minutes and 6 seconds to go, third quarter. Ouachita 28, Arkansas Tech 13. A reminder to join us again next Saturday night. We'll come to you from Carpenter Haygood Stadium in Arkadelphia. 5:30 for the pregame, 6 p.m. for the kickoff. Henderson State will be the opponent. Fair catch on the punt called for and made by Allie Freeman at his own 49-yard line. It is a punt of 32 yards by Tyler Dunlop, and excellent field position for Ouachita as they will get to start from their own 49 with 6:59 to go in the third quarter, and the Tigers leading 28-13. Braden Brazil has gone all the way at quarterback for Ouachita, 10 of 13 passing for 209 yards and 3 touchdowns. He's thrown touchdown passes of 14 and 45 and 75 yards. Handoff here to Shuncey Thomas. Thomas around right end, and he advances into Arkansas Tech territory to the 45-yard line. Pickup of, let's see, they may just say 5 yards to the Tech 46. And it'll be second down at 5 from there. Braden Brazil in the pistol formation on second and 5. Ball spotted at the Tech 46. Sweep to the left with Shuncey Thomas. Nearly lost his footing, able to turn it upfield and make positive yardage out of it to the 44. A pickup of 2. Forcing him to the ground was Alex Chambers of Arkansas Tech. The Wonder Boys led defensively so far tonight by Chris Kale with 6 tackles and Uriah Guy with 5. It's third down and 3 for Ouachita from the Arkansas Tech 44-yard line. We go under 6 minutes to play in the third quarter. Braden Brazil, 2 receivers left, 2 to his right. Quarterback draw. He runs straight ahead, spins off 1 defender, stays on his feet, and drags defenders 2 and just beyond the yard to gain. Braden Brazil again with great toughness on third down, able to pick up the first down. On third down and 3, he gets 4. It'll be first and 10 at the Arkansas Tech 40-yard line as the Wonder Boys shuttle in some fresh defensive linemen. Desmond Williams, Josh Little, and Kalen North among them. Also checking in on that defensive line for the Wonder Boys, Arian Banks. The linebackers right now for Arkansas Tech are Laval McNulty and Devian Smith. So 2 backups in at linebacker right now. Handoff to Shuncey Thomas. Thomas running left and runs into a pile of humanity at the 37-yard line following a gain of 3. Primary stop made by Laval McNulty of Arkansas Tech University. McNulty is a sophomore transfer from Western Illinois University. He previously played at St. Joseph's College of the Great Lakes Valley Conference before transferring to Western Illinois, so he comes to Arkansas Tech with experience playing at that Division II level as a consequence of his time at St. Joseph's. Screen pass complete to the far side. Penalty flag is down as T.J. Cole made the grab. He is stopped short of the yard to gain, but a likely holding penalty coming up against Ouachita will back him up 10 yards. It will move the football back to the 47-yard line of Arkansas Tech.
And from there, it'll be second down and 17. Correction, just illegal motion against the Tigers, so only a 5-yard penalty. So it'll move the football back to the 42-yard line. And from there, it'll be second down and 12. Stops the clock with 4 minutes and 33 seconds to go in the third quarter. Ouachita Baptist leading 28-13. Primarily because of the big play. Screen pass complete. Far side of the field. Allie Freeman makes the grab. And he is tackled inside the 35-yard line. Stop made for Arkansas Tech by Dio Williams. Makes the stop at the 34-yard line.
Third down.
Gain on the play was 8. And now it'll be third down and 4 for the Tigers. They need to get to the Arkansas Tech 30 in order to pick up the first down. Ouachita, 3 out of 7 on third down conversions tonight. Brazil takes the snap, throws, pass is caught by Tucker Swoboda, and he will have the first down at the 25-yard line, a gain of 9 on third down and 4. The Wonder Boys are fortunate that Swoboda lost his footing shortly after he made the catch because there was no one between he and the goal line. 3:34 to go third quarter. Brockton Brown is the running back now for Ouachita. Allie Freeman and Tucker Swoboda out wide to the right. Freeman is the slot receiver. Hand off to Brockton Brown. Brown running right. Slips past a couple of defenders. Gets inside the 20-yard line. And DeAndre Irvin takes him down on an ankle tackle at the 18. It's a gain of 7 on first down. And the Tigers are back in the red zone where they are 1-for-1 on scoring opportunities so far tonight. Their previous red zone trip resulted in a 14-yard touchdown pass from Braden Brazil to Allie Freeman early in the second quarter. That was part of 14 unanswered Ouachita points that gave the Tigers a lead they have yet to relinquish. Whistles and timeout is called by Arkansas Tech. 2:46 to go, third quarter. Ouachita leads 28-13. We pause for 30 seconds. Plus a station ID. This is Wonder Boys Football. .246 to go in the third quarter. Ouachita Baptist 28, Arkansas Tech 13. Tigers with the football. They've got it second down at the Arkansas Tech 18-yard line. And they need to reach the 15-yard line in order to pick up a first down. Brockton Brown is going to take a direct snap. Man in motion is T.J. Cole. Brown runs straight ahead. Good blocking gets him to the 15, and he carries it on down to the 11-yard line. Excellent patience there by Brockton Brown. If he'd just gone charging into the line of scrimmage, he'd have been stopped for no gain, but he was patient, allowed the block to develop in front of him, and then tackled at the 11-yard line following a gain of 7, and it's first and 10 for Ouachita Baptist. The Tigers have their 13th first down of the game. Clock rolling late in the third quarter, and Ouachita Baptist threatening to add to a 28-13 lead. Darren Kane and Carlos Gordon combining on that last tackle for Arkansas Tech. Brockton Brown brings a man in motion. Brown will keep it. Runs straight ahead, cuts back to his right, stays on his feet inside the 5, and Brockton Brown down to the 2-yard line to pick up a 8, maybe 9-yard lines. We'll wait and see where they put the football down. It's either at the 3 or the 2. They're going to put it. Well, they may put it all the way back at the 4. That may be where his knee was, where the ball was when his knee went down. Let's call it the 4. We'll wait and see what the official stats say. They agree. A gain of 7 to the 4-yard line, so it's second down and 3. Brazil back in the game. Now he'll shift out to the right. and Brown will again take the direct snap. Brockton Brown takes the snap, looking for running room up the middle. He is wrapped up short of the goal line and drug backward by two Arkansas Tech defenders. Primary stop made for the Wonder Boys by Geo Williams. And they will mark his forward progress down at the two-yard line, so that's short of the first down even. Now it's third and one for Ouachita from the three-yard line. And a big chance here for the Arkansas Tech defense to make a stop on third down and keep hope alive. Uriah Guy back in the game defensively for the Wonder Boys. It appears that Brockton Brown will again take the direct snap. It's third down and one. Wonder Boys getting in position defensively. Man in motion, Allie Freeman. Brown keeps. Brown dives into the end zone. Touchdown, Ouachita Baptist on a two-yard run by Brockton Brown. His second touchdown run of the night. And Ouachita opens up a 34-13 lead late in the third quarter, pending the extra point try by Gabe Goodman. Brockton Brown taking the direct snap, and again, that great patience to allow the blocks to develop in front of him. And he takes it in with 41 seconds left in the third quarter. Placement is down. Goodman's extra point is good. And our new score is Ouachita Baptist 35, Arkansas Tech 13. Let's pause for 30 seconds. This is Wonder Boys football. Scoring drive by Ouachita, 11 plays, 51 yards, 6 minutes and 18 seconds. Ouachita Baptist now leading 35-13 as the Wonder Boys get set to go back on offense and Jake Ford gets set with the kickoff. Kelly, what you got on the old GAC? Wait just a second. Never mind. I'll get you here in a minute. Caught Kelly mid-bite. How do I do that to my friend? Sorry about that, Kelly. I didn't check first.
That bird is good.
Jake Ford's kickoff is away. It will come down at the goal line to Kendrell Johnson. He bobbles it for a moment. Now he's got the football out over the 15-20. Penalty flag comes in. We're going to have either a hold or a block in the back against Arkansas Tech. Johnson able to bring the football out to about the 28-yard line, but it'll be all for naught because the penalty flag is down at the 17. Line and the preliminary indication is holding against Arkansas Tech, and so that'll be half the distance to the goal from the spot of the foul. And the Wonder Boys will have to start inside their own 10-yard line. And Kelly trailing the number 6 ranked team in the country 35-13 late in the third quarter. The game is not over yet, but regardless of whether or not the Wonder Boys can come back and win this game or not, this is an example of exactly what this season is about for head coach Kyle Shipp. He has talked and he has talked and he has talked about the fact that he wants his guys to finish no matter what. He wants them to play four quarters no matter what. He doesn't want to see his guys ever quit. And this will be a good chance to test that for the Wonder Boys right now.
Oh, it definitely will. You can get down in the dauber, 35-13, almost the end of the third quarter. You have to play hard. You have to keep playing every play. You never know what might happen. You just have to get that next score and move on.
Manny Harris's pass complete for a gain of 4 to the 12-yard line. Drew Wade making the reception. It is Wade's fifth reception of the night for 93 yards. Manny Harris now 15 of 21 as he goes over 200 passing yards on the night. Now 201 passing yards this evening for the senior from Copperas Cove, Texas. Russellville product Caleb Stokes checks in at tight end. He's a sophomore transfer, spent 1 year with the purple and gray folks in Conway before he saw the light. And that's how the third quarter comes to an end. Our score is Ouachita Baptist 35 and Arkansas Tech 13. We will step aside for 30 seconds and then come back with the fourth quarter. This is Wonder Boys football.
Ladies and gentlemen, Raymond James is a proud supporter of the Arkansas Tech Wonder Boys on Golden Side. For all of your financial services, contact Scott Langley at your local Russellville Raymond James.
just finished his snack, and is now prepared to deliver a GAC scoreboard update.
Well, it was 24-0 at halftime, Harding over UA Monticello. At the end of the third quarter, it's still 24-0, Harding over UA Monticello. It is Henderson State 27, Southern Nazarene 6. That was also the halftime score, and that is the end of the third quarter as well. Southern Arkansas leads Oklahoma Baptist 20-14, 5 minutes to go in the third quarter. Southeast Oklahoma 10. It is Northwest Oklahoma 9. No score there since halftime. And it's it's into the third quarter. Southwest Oklahoma still leads East Central 24-7.
Here in Russellville, it is second down and 6 for the Wonder Boys from their own 12. Manny Harris on the first play of the fourth quarter throws incomplete, and a penalty flag is thrown. The intended receiver was Brennan Lewis. Defensive back made contact with the intended receiver, but it appeared to be after the ball had already gone by. So we may have holding here before the ball went in the air rather than pass interference might be the call. We'll wait and see what they've got. And here's the referee to let us know, I think. Okay, he's got confirmation now that it was pass interference against Ouachita Baptist. And the spot foul is an automatic first down at the 15-yard line for Arkansas Tech. Deion Simmons checks in at running back. Simmons, the freshman out of Mayflower, was the Wonder Boys' leading rusher in week one with 90 rushing yards. In fact, he's came into tonight 7th in the GAC in rushing this season. And he will line up to the left of Manny Harris on 1st and 10 Tech from its own 15. Harris throws it incomplete to Deion Simmons as he couldn't make the grab out in the far flat. The incomplete pass will stop the clock with 14 minutes and 51 seconds to go in the fourth quarter, and Ouachita Baptist leading 35-13. It'll be 2nd down and 10 for the Wonder Boys from their own 15 as Simmons checks out, replaced by Caleb Beatty. Deion Senegal is the receiver to the right side of the formation. Out into the wide side of the field, it's Trey Smith and Drew Wade. Harris checks to the near sideline for the play call. Has it. Brings a man in motion. It's Drew Wade. Harris looking to throw, and it is short of his intended receiver, Caleb Beatty. And Caleb, when he sees that on film, will be thankful that it was short of him, because if it had arrived on target, Hunter White was there and ready to deliver the lick. As it is, it's an incomplete pass, and it'll be 3rd down and 10 for the Wonder Boys from their own 15. Harris now 15 of 23 passing for 201 yards. The Wonder Boys, 282 yards of total offense compared with 356 for Ouachita Baptist. Harris throws complete at the 23-yard line. Devin Allaway, freshman on the reception. Devin out of Marion, Arkansas, attended West Memphis High School. Makes the grab and goes out of bounds within the 24-yard line, a yard short of the yard to gain. And so the Wonder Boys on 4th down and 1 from their own 24 will line up in punt formation. Tyler Dunlop is the Arkansas Tech punter. So far tonight, Tyler's 5 punts have averaged 35.2 yards per try. This one is away.
Nice punt.
Spiral sends Allie Freeman scrambling back inside his own 30-yard line. Fair catch is called for and made. They're going to say at the 30, and that's where Ouachita will go on offense, following a punt of 46 yards by Tyler Dunlop, and there is timeout on the field. 14:09 left in Russellville. Ouachita Baptist 35, Arkansas Tech 13. We pause for 1 minute. This is Wonder Boys Football. we return to the action, first play for Ouachita Baptist following the punt results in Shuncy Thomas carrying the football all the way out to the Tigers' 48-yard line. And the play for Ouachita Baptist is 18 yards. And they'll have it first down at their own, first down and 10 at their own 48. Thomas, with that 18-yard pickup, now has 10 carries for 31 yards tonight. The Wonder Boys have done a pretty good job stopping the run, other than that one long carry by Brockton Brown. Here, a sweep to the left with Chauncey Thomas. He turns it upfield, runs through one would-be tackler, and heads to the turf at the 45-yard line of Arkansas Tech. The gain on the play is 7. And right now, that big offensive front in Ouachita, you can tell, starting to wear down the Wonder Boys' defensive front just a little bit.
Just a little bit. Starting to make some little bit wider gaps, room for those running backs.
This is a championship team for Ouachita Baptist. When there's blood in the water, they know it, and they go to finish things off. Hand off to Chauncey Thomas. He'll have the first down, got to get upfield at the 43-yard line, and then running inside the 40 down to the 37-yard line. A pickup of 8 on second down and 3. And with 12:44 to go in the fourth quarter, the Tigers on a drive that, if it results in points, could put this one away. Tucker Swoboda, who has a touchdown reception of 45 yards tonight, checks back into the game. He and his brother Hunter both have long touchdown receptions tonight from Braden Brazil. Hunter Swoboda's was of the 75-yard variety, so he'll have a little bit of bragging rights over his brother. His touchdown catch being 30 yards longer here tonight. First and 10, handoff to T.J. Cole. Cole around right end. Progress slowed by Kevin George, the junior transfer from the University of Colorado. And then Darren Kane, the Arkansas Tech senior defensive back, makes the stop at the 30-yard line. Gain on the play is 7. And Ouachita closing in on 400 yards of total offense on the night. The gain to the 30-yard line will make it second down and 3 for the Tigers. And much as they should be, they are in no hurry to get back to the line of scrimmage. Allowing that clock to waste away, we're down under 11 and a half minutes to go as they pitch it out to the right for Cole. Cole met by 3 Arkansas Tech defenders. Alex Chambers was the first man there. And then he received an assist from George Brooks and Devion Smith in completing the play. It will go to the 28-yard line, pickup of 2, and it is third down, really about a yard and a half here for Ouachita Baptist. Tucker Swoboda and Allie Freeman both check out as Ouachita is going to get into a power formation here. The Wonder Boys will answer in kind by sending in an extra defensive lineman in Kalen North. They're going to shift, and they'll direct snap it to Chauncey Thomas on 3rd and 1. Thomas straight ahead running. He will have the first down and a little bit more inside the 25. Met at the 23-yard line and pushed backwards. And so on 3rd down and 1, Chauncey Thomas able to pick up 5 yards. The Tigers have their 17th first down of the night. They are over 400 yards of total offense. And they've got it 1st and 10 at the Arkansas Tech 23-yard line with 10 minutes and 15 seconds to go. And a chance to add to a 35-13 lead. But first, Arkansas Tech head coach Kyle Shipp wants timeout. We will join Coach Shipp in taking a 30-second break. This is Wonder Boys Football. And 15 seconds to go in the ball game. Ouachita leading 35-13. They've got it first and 10 at the Tech 23. Coach Shipp calling that timeout for two reasons. First and foremost, he wanted to get his guys a breather here and try to give them a chance to get a stop, but if there was a particular point that he also wanted to make with the officiating crew.
Well, I think he did try to get a point across. They listened. Will it do any good? Who knows?
First and 10 for the Tigers at the Tech 23. Hand off to Shuncy Thomas. He runs up the middle, and what was quite possibly a touchdown-saving ankle tackle recorded for Arkansas Tech by Darren Kane. Ball carrier down at the 17-yard line with a gain of 6.
I've got a feeling there's going to be a long, long, long piece of film clip sent to the official's office. This
second down.
That could be.
There could be,
but with that aside.
With that aside, Ouachita, it doesn't matter. They're still very good at what they do.
Ouachita's been the better team here tonight, no doubt. Hand off to Shuncy Thomas up the middle. And carries it down to the 13-yard line. That'll be enough for another Tiger first down. They're just at an entirely different point in the progression of their program than the Wonder Boys are. This is a very senior-heavy Ouachita team, a program that has won two consecutive conference championships. Meanwhile, the Wonder Boys trying to rebuild after a 3-8 season a year ago. And really, when you analyze things, look at returning tacklers, returning ball carriers, all that kind of stuff, the Wonder Boys lost the overwhelming majority of the guys who produced on that 3-8 team a year ago. So in a lot of ways, starting over this year for Arkansas Tech. And there will no doubt be some growing pains, especially with such a front-loaded schedule. Hand off to Shuncy Thomas. Around right in, Alex Chambers pursues him and takes him out of bounds inside the 10-yard line. There's a penalty flag down on the play. Coach Shipp, he mentioned that he's talked so much to his team about not giving up and continuing to fight on. And part of the reason for that is because the Wonder Boys do have such a front-loaded schedule. Another very tough game next week at Henderson State. Then the week after that, another tough game at home with Southern Arkansas. But after that, with no disrespect to our peers in Oklahoma, after that, the schedule does get a lot more manageable once the calendar is flipped to October. There become several winnable games once you get into October, and certainly not forfeiting the next 2 weeks by any stretch of the imagination. The Wonder Boys will come out and compete against Henderson and Southern Arkansas. But as you look ahead to some of the Oklahoma Baptists and Southern Nazarenes and Northwestern Oklahoma States, some chances in October for the Wonder Boys to get some momentum if they can keep their heads up through this tough stretch in the schedule. There is an injured Arkansas Tech player on that last play. We will pause for 30 seconds. 8:55 to play fourth quarter. Ouachita leading 35-13. This is Arkansas Tech football. Alex Chambers was the Wonder Boy shaken up on that play. He is leaving the field under his own power, so hopefully that is a good sign. Meanwhile, the penalty flag that was thrown in that last play was a face mask against Arkansas Tech, and so it is a first and goal now for Ouachita at the 3-yard line. Braden Brazil is the quarterback, Shuncy Thomas behind him in a pistol formation. Brazil takes the snap, hands to Shuncy Thomas. Thomas runs left and stops short of the goal line. Tackle made for Arkansas Tech by Devion Smith. They will spot him down to 2 with a gain of 1. And it'll be second down and goal for the Ouachita Tigers. 8.5 minutes to go. Kalen North back in on the defensive line as Kevin George, a defensive back, will check out. Braden Brazil will again line up in a pistol formation with Shuncy Thomas behind him on second down and goal from the 2. Brazil calls for the football, receives it, gives to Thomas. Thomas between the tackles, churning legs, and he'll be stopped short of the goal line. Just inside the 1-yard line this time. And it'll be third down and goal from there for Ouachita.
Make a big stand right here, make a statement.
Some excellent fight on those first two plays of this and goal situation by the Arkansas Tech defensive front. A third and goal from the one. Try to come up with one more stop and then force Ouachita into a decision. Pistol formation again. Brazil, the quarterback. Shuncey Thomas, the running back. Brazil hands to Thomas. Thomas follows the interior of his offensive line into the end zone for a one-yard touchdown run. Shuncey Thomas, his first rushing touchdown of the night. He's got 19 carries for 72 yards. Ouachita now with 196 rushing yards as part of 423 yards of total offense. And there is a Ouachita Tiger shaken up after the touchdown. Down on the turf, just inside the goal line, it is the ball carrier, Shuncey Thomas, and this is significant for Ouachita Baptist from a long-term perspective. Thomas, their starting tailback, and he was slapping the turf in pain as he'd lie on his side. Members of the Ouachita athletic training staff out to check on him along with head coach Todd Knight. And while they look at Shuncey Thomas, we will pause for 30 seconds. 7:25 to go in the fourth quarter. Tigers lead 41-13. This is Arkansas Tech football. Working on Shuncey Thomas's right ankle area, and he is going to have to be helped off the field. One athletic trainer on either side. They will help him off the field as he is unable to put a great deal of weight on that injured right leg. And obviously you hope the best for Shuncey Thomas, one of the standout players in the Great American Conference, and hope this is not something that will be a long-term situation for him. As Gabe Goodman prepares the extra point for Ouachita. Shuncey Thomas is what appears to surely be his last carry of this game, a one-yard touchdown run that puts this one away for the Tigers with 7 minutes and 25 seconds to go. Gabe Goodman will attempt the extra point out of a hold by Jake Ford. Want to thank everybody who came out and made it a great family day crowd here tonight at Thane Stadium at Merkle Field. It won't be the ending that the Wonder Boy fans hoped for, but a great showing by the Arkansas Tech family here tonight nonetheless. Goodman's extra point is good, and our new score with 7 minutes and 25 seconds to play in the fourth quarter is Ouachita 42 and Arkansas Tech 13. Let's pause for 1 minute. This is Wonder Boys football. Now, Ouachita Baptist with the lead as the Tigers will win for the seventh time in the last nine meetings between these two programs. That last scoring drive, 12 plays, 70 yards, 6 minutes and 44 seconds. The Tigers doing exactly what you expect from a championship team once they got a lead. They have put together back-to-back touchdown drives of longer than 6 minutes to put this one away. Kendrell Johnson with the kickoff return. He brings it out to
Good strong run back.
It'll be first and 10 for the Wonder Boys from there. Hope you'll join us next Saturday night. We will come to you from the loveliest village on the Ouachita River, Arkadelphia, Arkansas, Carpenter Haygood Stadium, named for Jimmy Haygood, who was the athletic director there 100 years ago. Sporty Carpenter, who remains the all-time winningest coach in Henderson State football history, but Scott Maxfield, their current coach, is gaining on him. Sporty retired with 119 wins, and Coach Maxfield, that's a face mask. Coach Maxfield got to 100 wins last week. Carter Burcham is in at quarterback for Arkansas Tech, and the Ouachita defender, I believe it was Damian McDonald, just reached out and spun him to the ground via the face mask, which is not allowed in this jurisdiction.
I'm sure he didn't mean to. That's something you just don't. That's hard to do.
Regardless of intent, it will cost the Tigers 15 yards.
That's right.
From the end of the play, which was the 30-yard line following a gain of one.
And those are more of a safety thing than anything, because you can spin that head around pretty quick.
Yeah, the neck is not designed.
No, it is not.
Moves the football out to the Arkansas Tech 45-yard line. And from that point, it'll be first down and 10 for Arkansas Tech as we have just over 7 minutes to play with Ouachita leading 42-13. Handoff to Caleb Beatty. Tried to bounce it to the outside left. Nothing there, so he cut it back to the middle and able to make 3 yards out of it up to the 48-yard line. Good sportsmanship there by Zach Curry, senior defensive lineman, to help Beatty back to his feet after the tackle. And it'll be second down and 7 for the Wonder Boys. Reminder that the Golden Suns volleyball team, which won twice today up in Nebraska, will make its home debut on September 24th against Southern Arkansas.
They'll be at Harding on Tuesday, won't they?
Absolutely. If you'd like to make the 90-minute drive over to Searcy, if you're on Golden Suns Tuesday night, you're more than welcome to do that.
Be their first conference game of the year.
Caleb Beatty with a carry to the Ouachita 49-yard line. That was a gain of 3. Kind of 3 yards and a cloud of rubber pellets here on the artificial playing surface at Thone Stadium at Burkle Field. Back-to-back carries of 3 yards, and that makes
very well put.
Makes it third down and 4. There's an old saying about 3 yards in a cloud of dust, if you don't know what I'm talking about. Handoff to Beatty. Beatty went down in the estimation of the official on the far side pretty quickly, down at the 48-yard line of Ouachita for a gain of just 1. It'll be fourth down and 3. Well, maybe put it at the 47 for fourth down and 2.
Nothing to lose. Go for it.
Now they're going to back it up back to the 48, so it'll be fourth and 3. In at wide receiver is Devin Allaway. Tanner Gaines will check in and line up as a slot receiver to the right side of the formation. Carter Burcham, the quarterback. Burcham joined in the backfield by Caleb Beatty. Takes the snap, sets, throws across the middle. It is complete for a first down. Drew Wade down at the Ouachita 40-yard line. Tackle made there for the Tigers by Austin Guyman. And it is enough for an Arkansas Tech first down, a gain of 8 on fourth down and 3. The Wonder Boys improved to 1 out of 2 on fourth down conversion tries tonight and 3 out of 4 this season. Burcham now 2 of 2 passing tonight for 12 yards in relief of Manny Harris. Harris completed 16 of 24 passes for 210 yards. Burcham scrambling right, still wants to throw it, does so, and just throws it away into the near boundary under pressure from Ouachita's Rico Gonzalez and Austin Guyman. And it'll be second down and 10 at the Ouachita 40-yard line with 4:43 remaining in the Tigers. Leading the Wonder Boys 42-13. Ouachita will improve to 2-0 on the season. Arkansas Tech will fall to 0-2. Carter Burcham in the shotgun formation. Second down and 10 from the Ouachita 40. Throws near side, complete to Tucker Kennedy. He is upended by Keandre Evans. Evans makes the stop at the 37-yard line, a pickup of 3. And it will result in a third down and 7 for the Wonder Boys. It was
was Keandre Evans, who had the 100-yard interception return for a touchdown for Ouachita last year down in Arkadelphia that helped seal the Tigers' 24-7 win over the Wonder Boys a year ago. And the highlight of that and the call of it by our friend and colleague Rex Nelson was picked up by NBC's Sunday Night Football the next night as Keandre got a little national acclaim. Carter Burcham throws complete to Deion Senegal. Senegal out of bounds with a reception at the 25-yard line. It's a pickup of 12 on third down and 7.
Very good pass.
The Wonder Boys offense will stay on the field. Wallace Foote checks in at running back, replacing Caleb Beatty.
Trying to get on the board here one more time.
3 minutes and 43 seconds left to go. Burcham fakes a handoff, throws near side, complete for Drew Wade, and he gets clobbered. Waiting on him to deliver the hit was Keandre Evans. Also at the 21-yard line. Gain is 4.
Very good job hanging on to that ball.
Caleb Stokes in at tight end, replacing Tucker Kennedy. Kennedy is a sophomore out of Union City, Tennessee. Three receivers left for quarterback Carter Burcham. Takes the snap on second down, steps up in the pocket, and unloads as he was being taken down. It is incomplete. Intended across the middle for Trey Smith. It looked like it was going to be a quarterback sack. Then it looked like it might be a completion. Then it looked like it might be an interception. And it was none of those things. It was an incomplete pass. And it'll be third down and 6 from the Ouachita 21.
It just bounced around those rubber pellets.
Yep. No doubt. 3 minutes and 2 seconds left. Ouachita leading 42-13. Burcham takes the snap and misfires on a screen pass looking for Trey Smith. The incompletion will make it fourth down and 6. And the line of scrimmage will remain the Ouachita 21. The Wonder Boys will no doubt go for it here. Devin Alloway checks in at wide receiver. Tanner Gaines will check out. Burcham will have Senegal and Trey Smith to his left as wide receivers. They'll have Drew Wade and Devin Alloway to his right. Wallace Foote is the lone setback on fourth down and 6. Got to get to the 15-yard line to stay alive. Burcham throws across the middle. Trey Smith makes the grab near the 10-yard line. It'll be a first down for Arkansas Tech. Wonder Boys now 2 out of 3 on fourth down conversion tries tonight. Hopes that one more touchdown here tonight will stay alive for another set of downs.
22nd ranked Bisons of Harding. They complete their match tonight 24-0 over UA Monticello.
That Harding defense is something else.
Very tough tonight. They did not give up a single point.
Carter Burcham hands it off to Wallace Foote. He goes up the middle. He's wrapped up about the head by a Ouachita defender and taken down to the turf. Among those in on the stop for Ouachita, Austin Guyman, along with Zach Curry. They make the stop at the 7-yard line. And it'll be second down and goal from there. We go under 2 minutes to play. Ouachita 42, Arkansas Tech 13. Drew Wade in motion, handoff. And an attempt to run up the middle is met by the Ouachita defense as Wallace Foote stopped for it best, probably no gain. Primary stop for Ouachita made by Jamerick Waller. Waller wears 31 for the Tigers. He is out of Poplarville, Mississippi. A transfer from Pearl River Community College down in the Jackson, Mississippi area. Carter Burcham in the shotgun. Brings Deion Senegal in motion on third and goal. Here comes the pressure. Burcham from the blind side unloads. It is knocked away, incomplete. The intended receiver was Drew Wade. And there to bat it away for Ouachita was that man, Keandre Evans. He brings up fourth down and goal from the 6.
Give him credit for that one. He reacted well. Got the hand on it.
And Burcham had to hear the footsteps behind him, and yet still able to deliver that throw on target. Just the on-the-move part of it prevented him from putting enough on it to get it to the receiver before Evans could bat it away. So now it's fourth and goal from the six. Three receivers left. Caleb Beatty, I should say, is the setback. Burcham looks to be changing the play, takes the snap. Under pressure, running for his life back at the 25-yard line. He will throw it into the end zone. Nobody's there, and the Wonder Boys will turn it over on downs with 1 minute and 2 seconds to go. And Ouachita will need only to kneel on the football twice, and this evening's proceedings will come to a conclusion. Ouachita will win its 19th consecutive GAC game. And they are their bid to become the first football program to win three consecutive GAC titles. Will take another step in the right direction.
They're in the right direction for sure.
The big news for Ouachita moving forward out of this will be the condition of Shuncey Thomas. What appeared to be an injured right foot. Certainly hope that he is okay and able to come back for the Tigers sooner rather than later. Braden Brazil takes a knee. He will have to do so one more time, and then this game will be over.
It has gone final. Henderson State 34, Southern Nazarene 6.
And the Reddies will be the next opponent for the Wonder Boys next Saturday night in Arkadelphia. 6 p.m. kickoff, 5:30 pregame show here on River Country, KCJC and ArkansasTechSports.com. Braden Brazil takes a knee. Time will expire, and our final score tonight from Thone Stadium at Burkle Field is nationally sixth-ranked Ouachita Baptist 42 and Arkansas Tech 13. We will step aside for 1 minute and then come back and look at the final numbers. Wonder Boys lose. This is Arkansas Tech football.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for attending Arkansas Tech football at Thone Stadium at Burkle Field on this Family Day. Thank you for the support of Arkansas Tech Athletics. Please drive partners and have a great weekend. And go Tech!
Back to wrap this one up at Thone Stadium at Burkle Field in Russellville. A look at the final numbers. Ouachita Baptist with 421 yards of total offense tonight, 227 passing, 194 rushing. Arkansas Tech had 341 yards of total offense, 252 passing, 89 rushing. The Tigers were penalized 7 times for 53 yards. The Wonder Boys penalized 6 times for 51 yards. Ouachita had 19 first downs, 16 first downs for Arkansas Tech. The Tigers were 7 out of 11 on third down conversions. The Wonder Boys 7 out of 19 in that category. Ouachita 3 out of 3 on red zone scoring opportunities. Arkansas Tech 1 out of 2. The Wonder Boys maintained possession for over 33 minutes tonight compared to 26 minutes and 55 seconds for Ouachita Baptist. As the Tigers win this one by a final score of 42-13, individual leaders first for Arkansas Tech. Manny Harris completed 16 of 24 passes for 210 yards and a touchdown. Wallace Foote had 11 carries for 35 yards. Caleb Beatty, 10 carries for 21 yards for Arkansas Tech. Drew Wade with 7 catches for 105 yards and a touchdown to lead the Arkansas Tech receiving corps. The Wonder Boys led defensively tonight by Laval McNulty with 7 tackles. Chris Kale and Alex Chambers had 6 stops apiece for the Wonder Boys defense. Ouachita led tonight by quarterback Braden Brazil, 12 of 15 passing for 227 yards and 3 touchdowns. Brockton Brown had 9 carries for 85 yards and 2 touchdowns for the Packers, Shunsi Thomas, added 19 carries for 72 yards and a touchdown. Allie Freeman was Ouachita's top receiver with 7 catches for 84 yards. Tucker and Hunter Swoboda had 1 touchdown reception apiece for the Tigers. Ouachita led defensively tonight by Keandre Evans, John Johnson, Hunter White, and Austin Guyman with 8 tackles apiece as nationally 6th-ranked Ouachita Baptist wins this one by a final score of 42-13. And we look now to Kelly Davis for one last check of the Great American Conference scoreboard.
The only other two finals we have besides this one here is Harding 24, UA Monticello 0. It is Henderson State 34, Southern Nazarene 6. The other game still going on in the fourth quarter. Southwest Oklahoma 24, East Central 14. A close one, Southern Arkansas 27, Oklahoma Baptist 21. About 2:44 remaining in that game.